But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Hey, strap in, bitch. Hi, everybody. Welcome. Opie and Anthony program.
Yes, it is.
Hi, Jimmy.
Hi, buddy.
There it is. Just kicked in.
I look like such an asshole when I sleep with my stupid chin strap.
Do you have your little chin strap
and
on
a mouth
last
guard.
Night? How did it work last night? Did you sleep?
It's weird. I'm not getting good sleep, but I'm sleeping through the night. Like, I might be up once during the night instead of four or five times. I don't know what it's doing.
What's not good sleep? Are your eyes flittering a lot? Do you flitter?
No, but I look back and I remember being awake a lot.
Oh, really?
Like, one night I just kept dreaming of Jack Reacher, that stupid Tom Cruise movie, which I hate.
And
I just kept thinking about Jack Reacher all night. I kept waking up thinking about Jack Reacher.
What the hell?
I don't know why. This is the new Tom Cruise movie. It looks terrible. And I just kept thinking about Jack Reacher. And I don't know why. It's weird. Like, when you remember being awake and having thoughts, that's kind of what I've been dealing
with. Was it thoughts or dreams?
There's more thoughts than dreams.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like, the strap goes around my head, and I have to Velcro it to the very top.
Yeah.
Like a little bonnet. And it keeps my mouth shut.
Oh, dude, you should use it here.
You were actively thinking about Jack Reacher?
Or dream thinking. I don't know exactly, but I remember having a lot of thoughts about Jack Reacher because I hate the name of that movie so much. His name is Jack Reacher.
Ugh. You don't like it?
No, it's awful.
What's it about?
I don't know. Just a guy who does guy things. Guy with a gun who does guy with a gun cool things. He's Jack Reacher.
Is this the new one?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It appears to be Mission Impossible without gadgets.
Right.
Yeah, or Cobretti.
Cobretti. It really does seem to be like Tom Cruise made a throwaway movie.
Yeah.
You know, like he's got the... Tom Cruise usually has the big premieres, the giant, like, blockbuster movies. And then occasionally just makes these, that's a lot of money.
Like he did with, who's that girl, Katherine Heigl? Did he do a movie with her where they were, am I wrong, Kenny?
And there's really nothing.
Did you see the commercial where he's confronted by five
people? Yes, I saw that.
And he goes, I'm going to beat the shit out of three is, and the last two always run away. And then that's what happens in the commercial.
That's funny.
Jack Reacher.
Yeah.
That scares you.
Oh, it's terrible dialogue.
That scares you.
Yeah, he's not good for this role.
He's got like a Cabretti car.
Nothing to lose.
Is he a cop?
I don't know.
I'm a cop, you idiot.
I don't know. He's Jack Reacher.
What's Jack Reacher?
If he is, he's Rogue.
That's the nickname of a guy with long arms.
Yes.
Here's the fights.
Oh. You wanted this.
Oh, yeah.
You wanted this. Why don't they all attack him at once?
Really?
Oh, boy.
They run away.
He's shorter than everybody.
Of course he is. He's probably standing in little shoeboxes beating them up. He's jumping up and down.
He hangs out at the supermarket and helps old ladies get things on high shelves. That's his goal in life.
Jack Reacher. No, he works in a garage. Because he's a Jack Reacher.
It's terrible. It's one of those movies, you know, a little throwaway action movie with a horrible dialogue.
Yeah, but that's not good. Cruz is a great actor, I think, but that, I don't like that kind of cool guy dialogue for him. It's just not.
It doesn't suit him.
Suit him.
He wants to be an action star, though. Like, that's where he wants this part of his career now. He's just action star.
Like the Bruce Willis type.
Yes.
The fucking Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Why do you think so?
He did all of Mission Impossibles. He knows there's money in it. It's easy.
Probably overseas does very well.
Yeah.
Do you think they're easy compared to, like, really in-depth, like, Born on the 4th of July roles?
Oh, man. Imagine what you got to do to get ready for a Born on the 4th of July type role or something like that. And this one, you just got to work out, I guess.
Yeah.
Get all buff. And throw out horrible lines that are easy to remember.
You think he's like going and meeting the real Jack Reacher and doing research on what it's like to be Jack Reacher?
You think he tells everyone to call him Jack Reacher on set?
Mr. Reacher.
Yeah, when you come to my trailer to get me, say, hey, Mr. Reacher.
Everybody's got
to
call him JR.
Yeah, and then he comes out and says a fun line.
Yeah.
Yeah. Take me to the set, huh?
Yeah, if you're not scared, you should be.
Do you think he had to, they had to find short guys for him to beat up, or they had to do... I wonder if they ever have to shoot him in different height than other women.
I bet I bet it's all angles.
I bet.
Come on, scumbag, I'll kick your ass.
That's like his villains are Progeria kids.
They had to hire Al Pacino to be the big bad guy boss.
Yeah. It looks like they're just in a giant city. Like a big giant car tire next to them. They're fighting.
It's a dollhouse.
It's like a
twerps.
It's a Bug's Life. They're fighting and there's giant blades of grass around them.
Yes, they're using various small things for weapons. A matchstick. All right, we've made them really small.
Yeah,
we get it.
We've shrunk them. Lilliputians.
Yeah. I was watching fucking Bourne Legacy last night. I just figured, it's on demand. I kind of enjoy the Bourne movies.
I've never seen one.
They're mindless fun, you know. But now that's that new one. And they don't even have, you know, Jason Bourne in it. It's
no?
That other guy from Hurt Locker. And, although he's done more movies than from Hurt Locker, but I just go, the guy from Hurt Locker.
Jeremy Renner.
Jeremy Renner
I always
is
call
in
him
that.
Jeffrey Dahmer, because he played Jeffrey Dahmer in the TV movie.
Jeffrey Dahmer.
Mm-hmm. I always call him Jeremy Renner.
You do?
Jeremy Renner. Yeah, he's the latest fucking Bourne guy, but he's not Bourne guy.
Yeah, I love that, like, they did that, like, they obviously wanted to make another movie, and Matt Damon didn't want to do it.
Right.
So they just changed the story, and the big tagline is now, like, you didn't think there was just one, did you?
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, of course we did, yes.
Yeah. And, like, they're taking drugs and stuff to enhance their capabilities, and then they gotta kill all those, like, agents that are enhanced, and he's like, I don't know. But when you tune into one of these Bourne movies, right from the beginning, you feel like you got in the middle of the movie. It's one of those movies where you're like, oh, I hope they explain all this stuff. Because they just start talking about things without any explanation of what's going on.
Was it good?
It wasn't bad for for one of those kind of movies. You know, there should have been a little more action, though. I've got to be honest with you. They tried for a little too much storyline, not enough action. I want to see some fucking death and destruction.
Because they had to rewrite the story to include somebody who wasn't Matt Damon. They had to act like this was part of the story the whole time.
Yeah, yeah.
But they just made it up.
They just make it up.
And so now you have to rewrite the whole saga.
You don't think that they knew Matt Damon wasn't going to do this one? Maybe not.
Well, they knew when it was time to make this one that he wasn't going to do it. But when they were making the original trilogy or whatever,
they never got into that storyline. Yeah.
Right. So now they have to invent a storyline so they can keep making movies.
They had his photograph on screen for a couple of times in a little dossier thing. It's like, oh, that's him. Yeah,
remember?
There he is. Matt Damon.
It's a franchise still. It counts.
Yeah, who wrote those?
I don't know.
There's a huge author that wrote those.
Yeah?
Yeah, I see. Like, is it Ludlum or Robert? Like, you see James Patterson's a guy you see. Like, you know when you see hardcover in the airport, you know they're a big author. Like, when the hardcovers make it to the airport.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they only have softcover there usually.
Ooh.
And those little Hudson News things. And James Patterson's one of those guys.
Robert Ludlum.
Oh, it is Ludlum. Yeah. Okay.
Ah. And they use that, whoever the director is, does shaky cam. It's like when they're sitting at a conference table, the camera's shaking, and then it zooms in and comes back out. It's like,
like The Office.
Yeah, it was. It was kind of like, you know, it's even when they're just hanging out at a table, it's action-packed.
Yeah.
The camera's moving. Look out.
He doesn't even write these anymore.
Like, really?
Yeah, now it's Robert Ludlum's The Bourne Legacy, a new novel by Eric Van Lustbader.
So they just use his name.
Yeah.
It's the same thing they did to Matt Damon.
Right.
he's written, like, this Eric Van whatever has written 6 Bourne things. They have nothing to do with Robert Ludlum.
How many has Ludlum written?
Ludlum.
Jason Bourne is the guy's name?
Yes.
I hate the name Jason on an action guy.
You don't like Jason Bourne?
But is that really, I guess they're good books.
He wrote The Bourne Identity, Supremacy, and Ultimatum.
He only wrote 3?
He wrote the first 3.
And I guess he franchised it out.
Yeah, why not?
He created the character.
He's got other stuff to do. Like Star Wars. Like, anyone can write a Star Wars novel as long as it's, you know, approved by George Lucas.
Like WWE fan fiction.
Yeah.
That E-Rock likes to jot down and write.
He's already got the Royal Rumble winner picked out.
Wow.
That's right.
Wait, does George Lucas actually read them? I wonder if he does, because he's making money off them.
I think there's some sort of approval process. You can't just write, like, a Star Wars novel.
I'm writing one.
Oh, wow. Interesting. I'd love to.
Now you're
going
to have to go through Disney.
Yeah, because it's about Chewbacca.
Yeah.
It's called Chewie Gets Shoes. because he needs shoes because he can't get into any stores or restaurants.
Whole novel?
Yes.
Wow.
Will there be a chapter about a hat at any point?
Yes, Chewie's hat is chapter 7.
Yeah, I've seen some Star Wars fan films where they actually make like films, and people dressed as like some of them are very extravagant. Others, not so much.
Is there any where there's like a girl holding like a fucking a taser between between taser. Darth Vader and a an ugly unfuckable mope?
Oh, a blaster, right? Yes, yeah. a fat chubby little. I saw him this morning, fucking down the hallways. Which one is this?
This is
some Star Wars.
The Secret in the Sand.
Oh.
They use the iMovie fake Fox thing.
Yes, the fake Fox thing. A Gaz car. Yes, Gaz car. Very similar introduction. I'm sure they'll have a scroll yeah, on the screen. A long time ago in a galaxy far away. These guys are creaming thinking of this shit. And
do you want me to fast forward to the action?
Well, let's see. Yeah, this is they just bite the whole beginning.
Star Wars.
And now here comes the guy's story. Episode 1, The Secret in the Sand.
Ew.
Sounds terrible.
Martha lost her wedding ring at the beach.
It is a time of war, a time of rebellion, the time of the Empire. With each new star system captured under... Shut up!
Under surrender or purely by sheer force, the Empire is growing in strength. Great mystery surrounds Darth Vader's latest plans. The Empire has entrusted their best pilot with a mission so secret, only the highest-ranking Imperial officers have been informed. On a desolate planet, on the Outer Rim, the pilot has received a secret data plan that should... could change the outcome of the Empire and finally crush... Oh, yuck.
It's what a hokey little storyline.
A secret data plan, which means he can call in Canada for the same price. you think that's a good opening?
Oh, it's terrible. I could see these guys just jacking off, these nerds in their basement, just jacking it to the scroll. All right, how far are you going to let it go?
It has to go the whole way.
Now there's going to be the bottom. Down. Now, I haven't seen this. Bottom of a ship.
Yeah.
Very close view. Pan down to a planet.
Do you think the guys probably who made this, planet. Like, they look at, they watch it after they've made it, and they're looking like, we finally did it,
we
guys.
We did it, dude.
It's us.
All right, here comes, Oh, that's awful.
Yeah, that's not good.
Oh, God. These effects aren't very special. Oh, it's this very... two-dimensional planet. Oh, is that horrible? Oh, now the actors come in. I wonder how much they had to save up for TIE fighter helmets.
This looks like the graphics from the game Myst.
What's he saying?
Yes, this is terrible. You can't understand what he's saying because they use too much effect on his voice. And he's,
We got a green screen, guys. Look what we can do.
This is terrible. Could you go forward to where
what's
they're in...
What's he saying?
Talking to each other.
Who's Chewie?
Oh,
is this that fucking
blazing sounds?
This looks like blazing sounds.
All right, let's move on. Double time.
Do you think they location scouted?
Oh my god! Yes, they did. We need a
puddle. So they're in a.
See, it just looks like a pond. It doesn't look like Tatooine at all.
No. This doesn't look. This is the sand planet or something. It's very mysterious.
There's four stormtroopers. He got three other nerds to do this with him.
Yes, in full regalia, full Star Wars stormtrooper regalia.
And they're trying too hard to look like they're pointing their guns.
There was a little kid offset just chucking rocks at them and calling them nerds.
I would, if I was George Lucas, I would personally deliver a cease and desist to these people. Just hello. Yeah, saw your fan film. Oh, nice cut. All right. It's all, like, effecty. There's no...
And it's obviously royalty-free music.
It's all not right. Star Wars.
Yeah,
it's not John Williams music.
He said double time before. He said it before double time.
Oh, this is terrible.
It's a forest right by my house. We can film
He's got the same guys playing both roles.
Dude.
You got to tell your mom you got to hang out longer. We need an extra stormtrooper.
You think somebody didn't want to do it because they were going to get their stormtrooper outfit dirty?
Yeah. Guys, we got 6 stormtrooper outfits. We're going to have to get creative with shots.
Dude, I got the con this weekend. I can't get my suit dirty.
What's that red thing on his shoulder?
I don't know. Hopefully a fucking... I couldn't think of anything good to say.
Oh, because he's a...
It's a tumor.
Maybe he's the leader.
Thank you. Hopefully a tumor. Oh, is he team leader? How about double time?
He's kneeling in the...
Yeah. I feeling the grass
oh,
for?
This is
awful. Look at how difficult it is for him to kneel.
His suit.
His stormtrooper suit is making it difficult for him to kneel down.
They're all just excited to wear the cod pieces.
But he touched the ground and did the thing that you do with blood. Like you're sifting through it with your fingers.
Yeah, you run it through your finger. Oh my God, these blaster effects are terrible.
Oh no.
All right, guys, it's the big battle scene.
And they're using the same 5 guys for
look
both.
Look at the flames.
The flames are terrible.
Oh boy.
Oh my God, this is awful! How cheesy!
It's just...
Look at... the little fire. I can't even...
They're shooting at... The 5 guys they're shooting at are obviously the guys in the uniforms.
Yeah, they're never in the same scene at the same time, so they had to shoot it all as the stormtroopers, and then shoot it as the rebels.
Why would you do this?
Why are you wearing a World War II helmet? Oh, good death scene, dude.
Yeah.
You nailed it.
Royalty
How much
free.
Left is this?
Holy scream.
Double time.
12 minutes.
Oh, stinks.
Where's the secret of the sand, though?
Yeah, the secret of the sand. What happened?
They're on grass now.
They have some in their shoes, and they tracked it in the house. Mom yells at them.
Man.
They should do the secret of girls, and they all look at a vagina and try to identify it.
Figure out what it is. It's that fucking monster that swallowed Jabba the Hutt.
Oof. Password?
I once holidayed on Alderaan. Glad I took pictures.
What? This is so bad. Alright, enough of this. I've had it.
I can't go out today. I'm mastering the sound.
Yeah. Oh. It's another battle scene. This is terrible. All right, enough of this.
It's an action.
I don't know how we even got into talking about Wars fan films.
I didn't. We were talking about franchising, and I didn't realize that nerds actually did this.
Yeah, yeah. And that's really a typical one. That's not very badly done. It's actually their costumes are very good.
Mm. Are there ones with bad costumes?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, yeah. The other ones got some ones that they just made themselves with hats, various hats around the house and
galoshes.
I want to
see that. I want to see some of the just a regular guy with a Star Wars hat
and galoshes. That's awfulness.
Jedi uniforms out of sheets.
Oh,
yes.
Terrible. I don't understand the attraction to any film like that or any franchise.
You don't like the Star Wars?
It's fine. But enough already.
I think Star Wars got way over fucking rated.
Very much.
For some reason, because the first one was so huge. And then, Empire was kind of okay. You know, it was good, I guess.
Yeah.
But then that's it. Like, that Ewok shit, over. It was over. Don't even try to preach Return of the Jedi to me.
That one part of the movie kills the whole thing.
It's terrible.
I mean, it's an obvious attempt at merchandising.
Yes, yes.
Which is a shame, but it's not like Star Wars was a franchise with a lot of integrity to begin with.
No, it's
no,
a lot
that's
of...
just it. I don't know why people kind of have this impression that it's an amazing fucking trilogy and then another trilogy. The newer ones they made.
They
all
stink.
Of them stink.
I
Horrible.
Think they stink.
They're did you go see them in theaters?
Yes, I did.
I remember.
Yeah,
that was like one of the last times you actually had to wait in a line to buy because you couldn't buy tickets online yet.
No.
Yeah, I waited online.
I waited online for a stupid midnight screening.
Yeah,
zero
but it
interest.
Is fun when Star Wars comes on the screen.
Dun! And everybody goes, yeah.
I saw the first 3 in theaters. I no desire to see these at all.
What about the next 3?
Yes, I know. Now
the next Lucas
3
annoys me. He just bugs me.
Well, I don't even think he's got anything to do with it at
Disney
this point.
You know what? They might be good then.
They might actually make him good. Yeah.
I would love to see the ones that he has nothing to do with. Because whoever cast the Darth Vader, that good-looking guy, Christian.
Hayden Panettiere Christensen. Hayden Panettiere would have been more manly in that role.
Terrible.
What a whiny little bitch.
Has to be a good-looking guy instead of just the
Darth Vader. He doesn't have to be fucking good-looking. And what a whiny Darth Vader.
Terrible.
Like, my mother. So I killed him. I killed them all. I can't even watch it.
I was one of those that left episode one trying to make excuses for it. Like, well, I mean, it wasn't bad.
It sets it up for the subsequent ones.
You know, Jar Jar was. I mean, he had his funny moments, and
who's the guy that did the amazingly funny reviews? He talks like this.
Yes.
I asked because I was watching him do Titanic recently, like the other night. He has a new. It's a two-part Titanic one out.
That one.
And just starts talking like that. That's how he talks.
Why is he walking so far to go to the... Like, he calls out every little aspect of the movie.
Yeah, I didn't watch the Titanic. I watched like 20 minutes of the new Titanic. It's fucking hilarious.
Oh, I gotta see that one. I've watched
Red
all of
something,
his reviews. Yeah, it's something with Red in it.
Mr. What the fuck's his name? It's Mr. Something. Somebody sent it to me on Twitter. He's very funny. I don't know how he gets rights to the footage to show these clips. How do you put these clips online and not get in trouble?
Yes. I don't know. I guess it's very hard to get all those summonses and subpoenas out to just make people cease and desist. Are you allowed to do that?
Red Letter Media.
Red Letter Media. That's it. The guy's hilarious.
Yeah, I don't know if you're allowed to do it because, like, music and stuff, YouTube will just take it down.
This is his own site.
Oh, he doesn't do it on YouTube?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, well, then that's why.
But even a clip show like that, like if you're just playing clips, YouTube will take it down? It's kind of weird.
Probably.
I know if you put music on one of your videos, like YouTube kind of knows. They just know.
Yeah, within 5 minutes.
My wife uploaded, like, my daughter's ballet recital video. And it got taken down because the song that's played while she's dancing is copyrighted.
Well, it has to be some kind of a technology.
It's a
like,
program, yes. Yeah.
What's the technology like?
Like Shazam.
Shazam. Yeah. Right.
Yep. Mm. Yeah, it's the actual YouTube itself knows the music's there.
Right.
Yeah.
But like, for if you're just hosting it yourself, then you actually can wait until, like you said, Ant, they're sending cease and desist and stuff like that. So you can get away with putting it up for a while.
And they actually know, they can identify video, too. So if you put up, like, Major League Baseball or something or a TV show, they know just from the video. So that's why a lot of times people reverse it. So you'll see it in backwards because it doesn't pick it up, I guess.
They do that with wrestling.
Yeah. What? All the logos are backwards and everything.
They just reverse the video so the program can't pick up that that's a copywritten program because it knows what the video looks like.
Oh, they reverse it?
Yeah, so they just reverse it.
Who thought to do that?
I don't know.
Hackers. Well,
that's pretty smart.
First, they tried putting it upside down, but people were angry. Like, this is really stupid.
The programs on YouTube will recognize the logos?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Isn't that fucked up?
Wow, that's amazing technology.
Technology. Yeah, I dig it.
Yeah, so I don't know how this guy gets away with doing these really funny reviews.
Yeah, they're hilarious, though. I've seen that guy. I got to see the Titanic one. A lot of loose ends that he picks up on.
I didn't get that far into it. Maybe I got 15 minutes into it. I was just setting it up.
I could sit there and watch the whole
goddamn thing. It's a two-parter, and it was late.
Oh!
I had to put on my chin strap and get some sleep.
Yes. Get some snoozy time with your chin strap.
I had to put on my chin strap and wake up every fucking 35 seconds. Fucking zilch. Fucking body's betraying me.
Wow, that's got to suck.
More than you can imagine.
Oh, my
stinks.
God. I was having some dreamy dream that it's the oddest dream. And I've had this recurring dream for a while, too, where my old sheet metal worker boss, my boss from Apollo Air Conditioning, is firing me. And, like, he's asking me to hand in my keys to the truck. And I'm really, like, fucking freaking out about it. And then even in the back of my head, I'm like, wait a minute. I do radio.
Do you wake up in the morning trying to figure out whether or not you still work there?
Or No, I kind of know I don't work there.
Because, like, I have those dreams like that where I think, like, I'm in college and my papers aren't done or something and the semester's over. And it takes me, like, 3 minutes when I wake up to figure out and assure myself
that it's okay.
That I'm not there anymore.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would think I was still working in air conditioning when I first woke up. Like,
you should be.
Am I still working there, you know?
Yeah, those dreams are very strange. And I still have dreams about school.
You do?
Yeah, they never go away.
You don't have the stressful radio dreams, though.
No, I used to have those when we played music.
Mm-hmm.
I would have that dream that you know, the song's running out and you can't get to the CD in time. It's very frightening. But I've had those dreams where I'm back in school for some reason trying to get my diploma.
Are you you?
Yeah, I'm me at this age. And I'm fucking it up. I'm not going to class. I'm not... I finally give up and go, why am I even doing this? I have a job in radio. Like, it comes to me like, why am I doing this?
Yeah,
I got a radio gig. Why am I at work at Apollo Air Conditioning and upset that I'm fucking not on the job site and I'm going to get fired?
Huh.
What do you think that means, Jimmy? You analyze my dreams a lot.
Either I'm trying to think something to do with the fact that you're afraid of getting fired from here, even though you know it's...
Really?
Yeah, I would think so, sure. Why am I doing this? Or maybe the radio job in college relate to other things in your life. And you're like,
College, it was high school.
Oh, high school.
I was actually trying to graduate from high school in my dreams.
Just you cutting class at your age and smoking pot.
Call the teacher, teach.
Yes! Teach! Yeah.
The teacher's calling you, daddy-o.
Hey, teach, yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, it was really, it's really strange. I had that. I heard you talking about dreams like that where you wake up and you still think you're supposed to be
always
in school or
every time. It always happens on the weekends too.
At another job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know why. Like, stress seems to manifest itself, at least in my dreams, like the thing you were stressed about before.
Yeah.
Like, not what you're actually stressed about on today.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like, it's never the job you have now. It's what you used to be stressed about.
Ah, they don't make no sense, those dreams.
Mm-mm.
Craziness.
My catchphrase.
I know.
You never have a dream that you just run out of stuff to talk about?
No.
That you're just sitting here and you go, I got nothing.
Oh, imagine that. I'd just be like, where? Well, that would suck.
Oh, yeah, you just had nothing to say.
So what's up? But you can't have dead air, so you...
you try to get the callers to call in on the topic of what's up.
Yeah, we're having discussion today. What's up?
What's the weather like where you are?
Oh, no. They're not calling.
No one's calling.
Oh, God, I was watching that fucking show. What's that show that they put radio on TV?
Oh, Dish Nation.
Dish Nation. Last night, I'm trolling through the channels, and I see Dish Nation. I'm like, I gotta. So I put it on. Scott and Todd are like their stars. Like,
yeah.
They go to a bunch of different radio shows, but Scott and Todd, they feature them pretty prominently.
Well, it's because Todd has so many of those just snappy one-liners and voices and...
Does he do voices?
Yeah, it's always the same voice, though. He always kind of rag. Like, he just does this weird, like... pseudo New York, obviously put on voice.
To see Scott Shannon, though, actually see him as he's saying those things. He's another one that's talking over his dentures.
Yeah.
He's like, he does his voice like this, but he's also trying to talk over these big dentures. Oh, it's impossible to watch. Do we have some?
Yeah, it's hard to talk over dentures. Why don't they fucking fix that?
What the fuck is that about?
You ruined Star Trek for me.
Yeah.
I knew there was something wrong with the way Spock talked, but when you said he was talking over his dentures, I'm like, there goes that movie.
I shall be, I have been, and shall always be your friend. You are the captain of the Enterprise.
How humiliating.
Live long and prosper.
Oh, it's terrible.
He's worried they're going to fall out?
Yes. Why would a Vulcan have false teeth? And how come the Vulcans, who, like, if you watch Star Trek, you know the Vulcans live a lot longer than humans? Like, they don't age as quickly as humans? But he looks older than all of them. The fuck?
Yeah, he really... Well, how long was he supposed to be waiting? Oh, 25 years?
Yeah, I guess so.
They went through, what, the fucking... The zip hole?
The zip hole?
Whatever it was called.
He dropped in the bathroom, the zip hole.
He dropped his fucking... What, he dropped his strudel and he went to pick it up and fell into the zip hole. His dumb old man teeth. Fucking nose.
Where's Scott Shannon? Oh, Jesus. Here it is.
Sure.
I love this.
I am not our father.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, this is not logical. Your dentures are not logical.
There are so few Vulcans left. We cannot afford to ignore each other.
Then why did you send Kirk aboard when you alone could have explained the truth?
Because you needed each other.
Because
you... The revelation of all that you could accomplish together, of a friendship that will define you both in ways you cannot yet realize.
How did you persuade him to keep your secret?
Oh, he inferred that universe-ending paradoxes would ensue should he break his promise.
You lied.
Promise.
I implied...
A gamble?
An act of faith.
Faith.
One I hope that you'll repeat in the future is Starfleet.
Oh, I'm going to go to a better fucking denture doctor.
The Starfleet Commission and help rebuild our race.
Yes. And yet you can be in two places at once.
Oh. Could you tell me where you went for your dentures so I could go back in time and kill the guy?
Yeah. Don't go see Dr. Zell for your fake teeth this time.
That's terrible.
In this case, do yourself a favor.
Sure.
Put aside
brush
logic.
After every meal.
And don't forget to floss.
Floss regularly.
There's so much lens flare in this scene.
It's in every scene.
Well, would appear oddly self-serving. Yeah. I shall simply say.
Simply say.
Good luck.
She sells seashells by the seashore. I am Spock Brokaw.
Why does he use lens flare?
He
loves it. It's just his thing.
Looks action-packed.
It does?
Yeah, I guess.
Makes the room look alive?
Every fucking scene, that lens flare. I guess they cut down in the new one. Yeah. I am psyched for the new one. I'm a fucking Star Trek asshole with those fucking movies.
I'm looking forward to the new one, too. I think the first one was great.
It was really good.
Action. Although the version I saw was shot by some fucking guy in Chinatown, and we saw their fucking ankles and feet. In Anthony's theater, and did you realize how bad that copy? I'm like, what the fuck's happening?
No,
half the movie's gone.
I didn't realize how bad the copy was.
I'm like, what are we doing?
The top and bottom of the movie were completely cut off. So you're missing the top of people's heads, and not even just the top of their heads, like up to their eyes.
It was enraging, and fucking Ant's like, oh, it's all right. And, yeah, a little bit chopped off.
And it was choppy, like it was really choppy and digitized. It was a really, but you know what? It was, I think, the day it came out.
Do you have,
movies.
Now, do you have it on Blu-ray yet?
No, I don't get anything anymore. I don't get any Blu-ray anything. I just get shit on demand all the time. Fuck it. I'm not one of these people that are like, look how crisp and clear it is. I mean, it's good enough when you're watching it on TV. I don't care about Blu-ray.
I'm doing a little redesigning in my apartment.
Ooh!
My TV is like, I have a really good, it's a plasma. Which I know that they don't do them anymore, really. But it's a black outline. It's Pioneer Elite. It's the best fucking, one of the best pieces of technology I ever owned. It's amazing, the picture. What's that?
You should get a new TV.
But the picture still looks good.
But eventually those things are going to burn.
Are they?
Yeah. That's why they don't make plasma TVs anymore.
Burn, baby.
They really
burn.
Don't make them anymore?
No.
I probably had that
It's either
for
LED or LCD. You should get an LED.
I've had that
you
for
You should
over
get what Anthony has in his living room.
Over 6 years I've had that for.
But eventually those pixels are going to burn. And you're just going to need to go buy a new TV anyway. That's why they don't make plasmas anymore.
I feel like if you throw out a TV that's still good.
So sell it.
I'm only asking this.
Or give it to someone.
Put it in your bedroom.
It's a good set, dude.
Wall.
I paid a lot for that when it came out.
Did you?
Yes.
Isn't that terrible?
It's sad to think about how much you paid for televisions. Like, I bought my LCD, like, you know, 6 years ago. Probably for like, you know, $1,600, and now you can get that TV for like $900.
So the first few flat screens that were coming out, you were paying $10,000 for them. 10 grand.
Yeah, I can't relate to any of that.
Oh,
should I get
another?
Yeah. Give it to somebody and get another one? Maybe I should, because it's too big. I feel like it's wrecking my apartment.
You might as well now. I mean, you're redesigning your apartment. What better time to do it?
There's a new big badass Sony out on the market.
How big?
Oh, it's like 80.
That's too big.
What?
I have a 50. It's too big.
I want an 80-inch. I want 80.
Roland's got one of those 3D smart TVs.
Maybe I should get the 3D smart TV. Yeah, is it good?
Those are really going places.
Yeah. Is it good?
Yeah, you're hearing all about those 3D.
No, you're not. Oh.
Can you talk to it?
Yes. Roland loves sitting in his living room and talking to his television.
Hello, TV. Show me food commercials.
TV's like, what?
Yeah, what are you talking about?
Oh, my God. How does the TV understand him?
Just gay porn on all the time.
It doesn't know.
But they might not have better pictures than I have.
Oh.
You think they have ones with better pictures now?
They
than the one you bought 6 years ago?
It's a but it's a good fucking plasma.
Jimmy, you're so behind the times.
No, I'm not, Anthony.
The LED TVs that are out now, you probably don't even know how much better they
are. Yes.
I still have the one from
K-Rock?
K-Rock, but it's in my bedroom. I don't want to get rid of it. Because it was a free set, I feel like I'm throwing out. I'm like salmon that way.
Give it to someone.
It was a gift.
That's one
in my
bedroom. That's one in my my Manhattan apartment. Is the
oh, you still use that, right?
K-Rock, yeah.
But it's not as good.
No, it's terrible.
Is it terrible?
Now it's completely terrible.
Do they have them thinner now?
Oh yeah.
Oh,
that thing's heavy.
They're like a quarter inch thin now.
Now they're so fucking
yeah.
They're like this. They're like the back of the monitor here on my laptop. They're so light. You can pick them up yourself and just hang them on the fucking wall. Just like they said the future would be. Remember when they said, someday you're going to be able to hang your TV on the wall like a picture.
Mm-hmm.
And now you can do that.
It is weird. I remember hearing that. And you forget, like, every bar now has flat screens. Like, remember the idea of flat screen was so foreign? And then it just, all of a sudden, the old technology was gone.
It was impossible to think of because you just knew the technology of the cathode ray tube thing that had to be fucking 2 feet long and inside your television. Which made the big back on it. Whenever you moved, you'd pull the TV away from the wall, and there'd be that, like someone was barbecuing behind your television. The little fucking dust and heat thing on the wall it would leave. And you're like, oh, how are they going to hang a fucking TV on the wall with all this shit behind it? But then they figured out.
Maybe I should give it away. I wonder if I should put my fucking, the really good one in my room and then give away the K-Rock one.
Yes.
Give it away? Give it away.
Should I sell it? I don't want to sell it. It's not worth selling.
No one will buy it.
Then just put it in.
It's so cheap to buy a TV now.
I want to sell it, though. It's like, fuck, how long ago was that? 2008?
How much?
$2,500.
Imagine doing that. You wouldn't get a dime for it.
I don't know, but nobody probably wants it. It's probably too big and clunky.
In this day and age, you just buy a TV. They're so inexpensive now.
God, it didn't even occur to me to do that.
Oh, my God.
I'm looking because I have it. When you walk into my apartment, in the corner, I have a TV, which a big black screen on a big stand that you can turn into the other room. It just is an eyesore. It takes up too much room. I need like a little area, or I need to mount it on the wall quietly with a little swivel. There's no, my apartment's designed weird. There's no place. My living room, dining room area is very large, but there's nowhere convenient to mount a TV because you have windows.
Really?
Yeah, man. Maybe I. And if I mount it on the one wall, then I put the couch somewhere, then I'm too close to the TV.
Oh, that's bad for your feng shui.
No, but I don't want to be too close to the TV.
Yeah.
So I have to put it somewhere. I don't know what a good size TV is. I don't want an 80.
80?
That's too big for me.
Oh, 80.
Well, you think 50 is too big?
For my apartment, it seems like it because.
I just got 42.
Why don't you just fucking tack an iPhone up to your wall?
That's too small. But I don't watch TV that much anymore. Like I'm caught up on Homeland again.
I'm caught up.
The last episode wasn't unrealistic enough, so I wanted to go further into the fucking soap opera writing.
Is it really bad?
The acting is good, although Claire Danes' eyes are starting to annoy me.
What's wrong with them?
They're just she's fucking googly-eyed.
Does she have googly eyes?
Total Google eyes. The daughter on it. I fucking hate now.
Yeah.
I hate Damian Lewis's character. I want him to get killed. I hate him.
Is he evil?
Yeah, he's like one of the stars. Here's my theory.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I'm giving anything away because you know Damian Lewis is in season two. I think that they wanted to get rid of him early and couldn't because he won the Emmy. That's my theory.
You think they would write off him? He's like the big star, too.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like
she is, though.
Is she?
Yeah.
And I don't really know what the premise of the show is beyond season one. Like, you kind of wrapped up the whole, you know what I mean? Like, it's pretty obvious that in season two now, it's very much, I still like the show a lot.
It's a stretch, though.
But it's in comic book mode now. Like, it feels like a comic book movie.
Yeah.
That's Showtime, right?
Well, yeah, and they also, but they're not, they don't, they seem to take real issues and caricature them in a weird way.
Yeah.
But their argument
ripped from the headlines? Are they ripped from the headlines, as they say?
Oh.
Subject matter torn from the headlines.
Right, like in Law and Order.
I hate those. When it's like, hey, wait, I've heard this story before. Yeah. Kind of. Right. That was that news thing.
I think it's less to do with Showtime and more to do with a really good idea for a one-season show.
Exactly.
And then it's really hard to keep that going and going and going, because after a while, it's like, okay, he has to be caught by now. You know, like this story has to be over. But since it's so successful, you can't just end it.
Had the Sopranos. I mean, maybe you need more. There's enough good characters. Sopranos killed. If you haven't seen the Sopranos, and you're in season one, you have 5 seconds. Four, three, two. They killed Big Pussy. See, I lied.
But like Sopranos, it wasn't so narrow. Like Homeland is a very narrow scope. Yeah, the show is about a guy
who comes back.
Right, who comes back from war and is a terrorist. Yeah. And then once you find out, like, halfway through season one, so it's not a spoiler anymore, like, once he is found out, like, okay, you're kind of finished. Like,
Sopranos, there's a bunch of different crime storylines, his personal life storyline.
Yeah.
You could kill off a main character, but there's so many other... It's a real big ensemble cast.
Sopranos is just Tony's, like... It's the mafia meets his family life. Yeah, so it's his whole life.
Right.
See, I love her in it. I think Damian Lewis annoys me. Even though I know he's a good actor, he annoys me. I heard SNL parried him because of his tiny mouth.
Really?
Which is funny. I think he's good. But I think the guy who
plays...
You know,
he's British.
Is he really? That's amazing to me. That shows you.
Very, very British accent.
It's not surprising.
So weird to see...
like when Andrew Lincoln came in for Walking Dead.
Yeah, it's like, stop it. What are you doing? Yeah. Wait a minute. You're not English. What are you doing? Stop with that accent.
he's really good. Who else is good? The guy that plays
Mandy Patinkin.
Saul.
Saul is great. Yeah, and who's the black guy that plays the head of the agency? He's also excellent.
Oh yeah, he's good.
Mandy Patinkin.
Is that the guy's name or a girl?
That's Saul's name. Mandy Patinkin.
Oh, okay.
He was in Yentl.
Is he British too?
He's in today.
He's in today.
Yeah. He's where?
In the building.
Saul?
Yeah.
Dude.
When? This afternoon.
Oh, yeah. Jimmy. Look at Jimmy. Jimmy just like, wow.
I didn't know. I like him.
Yeah? Going to get a picture?
What time is he here?
I think one-ish.
No, before that.
Oh, man. Yeah. I would love to meet him.
I think he's doing Ron and Fez.
Yeah, Ron and Fez around at one.
He's great.
Oh.
Hmm?
I don't know.
Doing Ron and Fez.
Yeah, I mean, all the actors are good on that show. It's a fun show to watch, but it's like, it's not like... a realistic show anymore.
Mm. No, but it stinks, and it really annoys me that they've cartooned it so much. Because again, the acting is still great. The guy he's talking about is great. Saul's great.
Yeah.
And there's other storylines. I would rather just see it be a good show about homeland terrorism pursuit. Like,
yeah, you'd have to start like you'd have to eliminate the Damian Lewis character, and then season two.
Oh, get him or kill him! I fucking hate him.
Season two, it's a whole nother case.
I hate him.
Really?
Hate him. I hate his fucking character. I want him shot.
Yeah,
but there's also like there's no way Claire Danes would still be working for the CIA.
No, of course not. But she could still be somehow. I can like you have to suspend disbelief for television. I can understand when they put suspend belief. What are we watching him talk?
Let me hear Damian
Lewis. Here's Damian Lewis.
I've never heard him actually. So, this is Jonathan Ross show.
Your performance in it, which is central to the whole success and quite a thing to carry, I would have thought, that whole show. But you've been praised and lauded for it quite rightly. Just won the Emmy for it as well.
Yes, I did. Very nice of you to bring that up so early.
It's happening.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah, very nice. Very nice. My children actually thought I was nominated for an Emma. So the Americans didn't like
it. It doesn't make any sense.
Why are you talking like that? Stop faking.
He is so good at eliminating that English accent. He was in he was the lead in Band of Brothers, and just fantastic. He was so good in that.
He's a great host too.
He gets a lot of people.
Jonathan Ross and fucking Graham Norton get everybody.
Graham, what an English name that is.
Yeah, he's a little. I think a gay man, and he appears to be.
Is he a slight gay man?
But they have those are great shows, man. They do get every fucking Hollywood actor goes on those.
Yeah,
everyone.
They pay to fly them over and pay for them to be on the show too.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Really?
They pay them to be on the show?
Yep. You get booked like a job, and they cover all your expenses, your travel, and they pay you to be on the show.
But wait a minute, that doesn't make sense to me because the movie studios would fucking easily pick up travel to have De Niro on a show.
because some of these movies, when they know that it's not going to be overly huge internationally, they'll book through, like what Roland does, through talent booking, stuff like that, and they'll book them to get over there.
How does he know this?
I don't know. And the answer he just gave didn't address Jim's question whatsoever.
My question is this. Like, if you're going to have Dustin Hoffman on one of these shows.
Ooh, when?
The movie, well, that's a big secret.
Oh.
The movie studio would gladly pay that. Whatever Jonathan Ross's show is going to pay, the studio can afford. Yes. So they would pay to do it.
Not according to Eric.
Uh-huh.
Talk to Roland when he comes in. He can explain a little better.
In private.
Roland can explain something better?
Yeah, what? That doesn't make sense to me for that reason, because the level, like Will Smith.
He was paid to come on the show.
Maybe they paid, but how much could they pay Will Smith to make it work? And he makes $20 million a film. Like, yeah, what are they going to pay him, $50,000? Yeah. Which I guess is nice.
That's a lot of fucking money, though, for to be on a show.
It is, but why wouldn't the studio pay that for you to promote? That's in your contract.
Right. And where does that money come from? Geez, 50 large for one guest? It's crazy.
Those shows aren't, well, like Graham Norton goes in season, so he'll do maybe 12 to 20 episodes, and then he's off for like 4 or 5 months and comes back.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know that. He's not a nightly show?
He's a weekly show.
Graham Norton's a weekly show?
Yeah.
Oh.
I did not know that. Okay.
How does Eric know all this?
Eric Nagel of the Hollywood Nagels.
What's that?
Eric loves British TV.
Oh, that's right.
Okay, so
okay.
Graham is a weekly show. That's a different...
And he's seasonal, too, so he's not on for the entire year.
I had no idea. How great of a host is he?
He's very good.
He's fucking... I've talked about him before. The set is very colorful.
Yeah.
And he has the guests on. You know how we do in here, kind of? He does the same thing, just with bigger guests and better. But it's where he'll have, like, I saw one with Ozzy and Sharon and Gervais.
Right, right.
And while Ozzy is talking or Sharon are talking, then Gervais is just sitting there through the interview.
That's great. Like, that's the old Johnny Carson way of doing things when, you know, they just move over on the couch and still kind of have some interaction with the guest that's still in the chair. Like, that was always a cool thing back in the day.
I thought that was a nightly show, though. I didn't realize that.
Really? Is he the
homosexual? Look how colorful his studio is, though.
It really is. Those English, though, have been like that for years. They love a lot of colors. They love splashing color on things.
But look at the beautiful purples. It looks like a fun like Graham Norton, whoever does the opening for his show, it just looks like a really fun place to hang out.
Ooh.
And the set is great. Like, this is the type of show. Look at that. It's fucking amazing.
And all the guests are out at the same time.
Yes.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
It's a huge fucking studio. You can fast forward to when he has guests. I want to see who he's got. I don't care what's modeling.
Oh, those English people. Oh, that's the one with Gervais.
Yeah, I just want to see what it looks like when they're all sitting there together.
Yeah.
Does he brings them all out? Is that, yeah.
Looks like someone's, like, bad living room furniture.
Yeah, it does, but look at how much fun that looks like to be there.
Yes. Gervais is there, Ozzy, like, Sharon.
It looks like it's pretty similar to the Bravo show.
Really?
Watch What Happens Live,
yeah.
Really? You watch that?
I have.
It's like that show on Logo. See, that's the gay channel.
You turn it off. I just wanted to
that
see.
That is pretty cool, yeah.
Yeah, and they're all talking, and it's comfortable. None of them feel left out, which is, makes him a really good host.
That's what Watch What Happens Live is like.
Is it? Okay. Mm-hmm. Who hosts that?
The guy who's in charge of Bravo. That guy.
Andy Cohen.
Andy Cohen, yeah.
Is it good?
Andy Cohen?
Sam's watched it a lot. Oy. He loves it.
Apparently has.
Well.
Jay Moore does
it.
Fucking Peter Pumpo.
You shut the fuck up.
Sorry. Oh, man. Sammy.
It's cool.
But I want to do it. What were we talking about to get on the British TV?
Yeah.
Well, we started this. Yeah, we started with Scott and Todd and then...
It was Homeland, yeah, and then the English accent.
That's kind of the way it should be, all over the place.
The English accent that Damian Lewis is so good at.
Whereas Walking Dead...
Yes, he's so good at doing that English accent. What an asshole.
I think Walking Dead is getting... like Season 2 is good, but Season 3 is really good. Like I like it a lot.
It's fantastic.
Because the zombies are interesting, but I like where the storyline is coming.
Yeah, this whole... You could only go so far... in a show with zombies, of killing zombies, you know? Now you need that whole people against people thing. Mm-hmm. People! Yeah,
well,
you need
that's why the tagline was, fight the dead, fear the living.
Jesus, I hate a tagline.
Me
you don't
too.
Like a good tagline?
I hate a tagline. Yuck.
Yeah.
Just show the shit already.
I already for the Jim Norton show, which I'm writing.
Oh.
It's an action adventure.
Oh.
I have a tagline.
You got a tagline?
Yeah.
For the Jim Norton Show, action adventure.
Yeah.
What is it?
It's not all Melba. Dot, dot, dot. You know what
that's
I mean?
Terrible.
That's a bad one. It's not all
that
Melba.
That is an awful one.
Do you have a tagline for your advice show?
Oh, you should have a tagline for your advice
you
show.
You need a tagline.
Yeah.
Take my advice. Not.
That's a good one. It's better than the shit that would have been in this slot. What well, about that one?
A direct shot at me.
Ah. Was it? I didn't even notice.
I start tomorrow.
Are you nervous?
Tomorrow.
At 10 a.m. No, I'm not.
First day on the
job. Probably shouldn't be. You do radio a lot.
I know. I'm just kind of sitting in the same chair.
Yeah.
Open Ant will leave and you'll sit there and
I'll be listening on the way home.
Exactly.
It'll be fun.
Travis will pop in. Be the same dummies I see fucking 5 hours a day anyway. My first day at school. Where are you going? Right here. It's like going to school at home. It's like all of a sudden my first day of college. Where are you? My mom's teaching me. My fucking dad's the assistant principal of the college.
What you're gonna take calls and stuff and
yeah, but I've actually been printing out emails and I've actually been writing for this one. I said actually twice.
Why would you prep more for your advice show than you do for this show?
Oh, a lot more.
Well, this show, the kind of, you know.
But look where this show, how would you prep itself. For this show? That's why I don't do prep for this show, because I love the way this show goes. All
I like
over.
It too, just, you know, whatever's in the news, whatever yeah. we're talking about, whatever happened the night before, shit like that.
I prep for interviews. Like, I'll write down questions for interviews, or I'll watch a movie, or I'll read a book for an interview.
Right.
To be respectful, if I can, but I don't, what is it a prep to, like, you know. You just hang out and chat, and maybe
yeah, what's
be
gonna pop? What's gonna pop in my head at 9:15 tomorrow?
Does that mean we can stop prepping too?
No.
We should start actually.
Yeah, I stopped years ago.
But so. I have a bunch of I wrote just a bunch of thoughts to say to people. Not like yeah, I'm not gonna read a script, but just like you know things I would answer their questions or their suggestions, and most of them have been actual real questions. I'm surprised that like 80% of them have actually been legit fucking.
You got a sample of a question, kind of. Jim,
I'm not too sure what to do about work. What do you think? It's like, Jim, I'm not good at my job, but I stay here out of force of habit. What should I do? Sam R.
Must be somebody with similar initials.
No, I got one guy who I actually wrote him. I wrote a couple of them back. Yeah. And one
girls?
Guy. Yes.
Hi.
It's funny. You should
I think
say
a
that.
Private session is more in your future.
But one guy was having a hard time, and you know, like real, like legit, fucking.
Wow, real problem. Ugh. Oh man, you got to fucking worry about like what kind of advice you're giving.
Yeah, but you got to know where you're coming for advice. I'm not exactly Dr. Fucking Phil.
That's true.
Just don't give any nurse receptionist advice.
That was the tagline. I'm not exactly Dr. Fucking Phil. That should be my tagline.
It would be a good tagline, yeah.
Yeah, but I got to do it, so.
But it's like some harrowing questions. People were really like, into shit.
Yeah, like fucking really.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Like, yeah, like fucking, you know. Thanks, Eddie.
Oh, God.
I know.
People that want to maybe, you know. Take the what they call the coward's way out.
Yeah, the fucking final plunge.
I love how they say that. The coward's way out. Yeah, you do it.
It's hard, man.
It's fucking crazy.
Killing yourself is not easy. I mean, the guys that do it, but to actually go through it is fucking hard.
Yeah, that's got to be fucking crazy.
I don't recommend it.
I wouldn't either.
Is that your first bit of advice?
Yes, I don't recommend it.
Don't recommend suicide.
But I don't know how the calls are going to be, so I'm like, fucking have some questions.
No, the calls will be, you have calls the whole time.
I think so, too, but like, want, like, you know, I want, it'll be silly and funny, but it's like, I want to have some questions that make, you know.
Yes.
I kind of want to just do the Opie and Anthony show again.
You're going to see another side of Jim Norton.
No, you won't. It's the exact same side you see all the time. I'm a one-level fucking one-trick pony. It's going to be fucking fart references and dick jokes and fucking chips. Please. Tune in with no expectations.
Yeah, well, if they're used to this show.
Exactly. And the shit show.
I'll have no problem tuning in with no expectations.
I'm not exactly replacing fucking...
Yeah.
I couldn't think of a show.
Oh, good. I was bracing myself for impact.
I know, right? You want to take a break, and then we'll come back. And I definitely, there are a couple of things I wanted to discuss. One of which was the Zimmerman Trayvon case. It's a little news. I guess Zimmerman's lawyer is going after a few people that have
good
been unfair to him.
Good.
And And there was something else.
The fucking execution right outside our old building.
Yes. That's huge.
Awesome.
And then and then more like developments on that Australian fucking radio show thing. I always say this. And then they just disappoint me wholeheartedly. But we might take some calls today. Whoa. I don't know.
I say we take some calls today.
We'll give it a try.
Let's be a part of instead of a part from.
Right.
Oh, that's a great motto. Advice. More advice. Thanks for the advice.
Feelings are not facts.
Yeah.
No one wasn't as good.
That was very good. It's very true, too. Because you feel a certain way. It doesn't make it a fact.
No, I get it.
I'm dumb.
Yeah. All right, we're going to... let's all eat.
Out.
Let's all eat.
The Opie and Anthony Show.
What I got, you got to give it to your mom. Yeah. This one, the Peppers were good. Peppers kind of fell off, didn't they? I think it was a whole time and place thing, you know? That funk thing. And it just got silly. I always liked the Peppers, though.
Oh, yuck.
Until they got stupid.
I hate this song. Give it away, give it away, give it away now.
You don't
give
like it away.
It's fucking terrible. Give it away now. Fuck you. Terrible. I think they're the most overrated band in history.
Really?
Can't stand them. One great song. The rest of it's fucking awful.
The early Chili Peppers Under the Bridge is pretty goddamn good.
Play me another. California.
No, that's like
it's
later.
Okay.
That's later.
Play me another a good one. What's one of their quirky album names?
Play like...
Beard, Hair, and Eyes.
You don't like Blood Sugar Sex Magic?
No, I don't. It's stupid.
Play something off of...
So he's a great bass player, though.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I'm not saying they're not great musicians.
But don't work with Flea. He'll rat you out to your boss. McFry!
I don't... Wait.
Oh, what?
A trite here, beat.
He's not going to like when it kicks in. Here it is.
Average. Too much like a rap. It's too much like a white rapper. Hey,
it's
motherfucker,
kind of
don't give a damn.
It was kind of a funk based rap thing. Funkadelic. Yeah.
I hate him.
I kind of liked it. I liked
it. Give it away, give it away, give it away now. Ho, 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 ho.
Damn it. Like tomorrow is the big 12-12-12, right? Is that tomorrow?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Tomorrow's 12-12-12-12. Is that televised? Yeah.
Yeah,
on Epix.
It's on.
It is on Epix.
Is it?
Yeah, they're simulcasting. Where else is it? Other places.
I think it's on
Showtime's
a couple
got
other
it.
Channels.
Showtime.
Yeah.
They say bigger audience than Live Aid. It's going to be bigger than Live Aid.
Yeah, they're broadcasting all around the world.
Bigger than AIDS.
Bigger than AIDS, huh?
Bigger than AIDS. Who's going to be there? Who's
Everyone.
Actually doing this?
Eddie Vedder is, I think, headlining the whole thing.
What? Yeah.
Is he really?
Well, no, he's on.
He's one of the people going.
Are we
going
to get to hear him talk? That'll
Probably.
Be good.
Let's see. Eddie Vedder.
McCartney's headlining the thing.
McCartney, yeah.
Kanye.
He'll probably want to go out after McCartney. That cocky douche.
The,
a dummy who wanted to go on after Metallica at Lollapalooza to be on the main stage. And ooh, did he bomb.
Really?
He did?
Oh my, not Lollapalooza. What's the one in fucking the South that I performed at?
Bonnaroo?
Bonnaroo. That fucking asshole Kanye was on a smaller stage. I want to say after Jack Johnson or whatever the guy's name is. And dummy has to, you know, baby boy has to be on the main stage with his full dog shit stage show. Metallica headlined the main stage.
Yeah.
So a couple hours later, they fucking load baby boy's fucking thing on, and little widow baby boy goes on, and the sun is coming out, and he has this whole fucking stupid space theme show, and he fucking bombs.
Yeah?
Yeah, you don't remember that? Like 2008.
Oh, I guess so.
Or maybe 2009.
Good. Good for you.
Bon Jovi, Eric Clapton, Dave Grohl.
Layla!
Fucking shut up.
I love how Jim hates one of the best guitarists.
He's a great guitarist, but I hate him. I hate his music, and I fucking hate the fact that he was fucking George Harrison's wife behind his back. Even though Harrison was fine with it after a while, I still hate. He's a little fucking snake. He's a jealous little snake, non-Beatle. Fuck him.
Dave Grohl. Uh-huh.
I love Dave Grohl.
Everyone
Dave Grohl.
Licked my head. He was here yesterday.
Was he?
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
He saw his photos.
Yeah.
I love Dave Grohl. Billy Joel.
Yeah, I like Billy Joel.
Alicia Keys.
Okay.
Chris,
I like her.
Chris Martin.
She got a weird body, Coldplay. Alicia Keys.
She can sing, though, man. She's
Yeah. She got, like, a pretty face, but her body is fucking whack, yo.
She does have a strange body.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's weird.
Big ass.
Yeah, but it's not like a, like, it's almost like big and kind of squarish.
And flat and square. Oh, yeah, square
it's,
ass.
It's from always sitting on that fucking piano seat. That's why.
Oh.
Starting to look like a piano fucking chair.
Oh. I never thought of that.
Yeah, she's always sitting.
Right. Who else is going to be?
Bruce.
Bruce. How much Bruce?
I think they started at 150 and then but it's all for charity.
Yeah.
And then they went up to a couple thousand.
How much time is everybody doing?
I would assume they're all doing like one or two songs because there's so many.
Imagine what backstage has got to be like
oh
in
my
that
God.
Situation. The pandemonium.
Yeah, but the access is probably so limited backstage.
Oh, I know, but just the yeah, exactly. But all their own security people all there keeping like
butting heads.
Oh yeah,
and you know Kanye's gonna walk in with 12 people
of the entourage. Kanye will have fuck Kanye.
I can't see. He's a very talented guy, but I can't stand
Izzy.
Him.
He's awesome.
Izzy. Oh okay, yeah. I was just asking. Izzy. Who else?
So Bruce Springsteen, Eddie Vedder, Roger Waters, Kanye West, The Who, Paul McCartney.
Who?
Rolling Stones were added.
The Stones are doing it?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Huge.
I wonder why Jay-Z's not on the show.
Oh, my fucking God. Is that a lineup? Wow.
That's pretty huge, man. What?
God damn.
You know, this is all for you.
I know. That's why I didn't even want to buy a ticket.
It's for you.
It's just going to me.
It's going to you.
At the Garden?
Hurricane-ravaged fucking
Like, shouldn't we just
town.
Get in for free?
Yeah, you should.
Can you imagine the fucking backstage McCartney and the Stones
oh
in the same
God.
Area?
You think anybody's going to be able to sneak back?
Oh, lots of celebrities will be there, too.
Yeah.
Oh?
Steve Buscemi, Jessica Chastain.
What? What are they going to do?
Sam?
Yeah, come out on stage?
Probably.
Actress.
Yeah,
ladies
say, like,
and
donate
gentlemen.
Now, blah, blah, blah. Chelsea Clinton, Sean Combs, Billy Crystal, Leonardo DiCaprio, Jimmy Fallon, Jake Gyllenhaal, Seth Meyers, Chris Rock.
I couldn't handle being there with my camera.
Adam Sandler.
Oh,
Susan
my
Sarandon.
God, right?
Yeah,
you'd lose
nuts.
Your fucking mind, Jimmy.
Quentin Tarantino, Brian Williams.
That would have been a great thing to sell. For $1 million, you get a photo with every artist there.
That's a big one.
Who would pay $1 million?
Not $1 million. Or whatever
Jimmy would if he had
$1 million.
He would try to find $1 million.
If he only had $1 million, he would give it all just to get that in that situation.
Come on, because you'd have McCartney. You'd have the Stones as a band. You'd have Billy Joel.
Yeah.
Maybe not as $1 million, right?
Yeah, you're right. It's on like every channel.
Oh, it is.
AMC, the Cooking Channel. Encore, Epix,
the Cooking Channel,
FX, Fuse, G4, HBO, like everybody's
HBO
showing.
HBO Latino.
Yeah, MSG, MSG Plus. Right.
Who's the actual headline act, the Stones or McCartney?
I'm assuming it's going to be like a big, you know.
Because the only guy that can go on after the Stones is McCartney. Like if McCartney goes out and plays Let It Be, he can follow. There's no one he can't go on.
I'm going to guess it's going to be the Stones and McCartney.
No, but one of them will have to go out and one will join the other.
Yeah.
Yeah. You think Mick Jagger will join in? Mother Mary, come to me!
Come to me! Mother Mary, come to me!
I'm going to bet Paul McCartney.
Did you hear about this Rolling Stones the Rolling Stones concert this weekend, right?
Yes.
And they're putting who? Lady Gaga and...
Lady Gaga, Bruce Springsteen,
and Bruce Springsteen.
And the Black Keys.
All on their show.
On the stage with them?
Yeah.
It's going to be a pay-per-view.
Yeah, it's a pay-per-view. It's the last show of their 50th anniversary tour.
Whoa.
And so they're adding Gaga, Bruce, and the Black Keys to their stage show.
I did hear that. Black Keys are big, right?
Very big.
Yeah.
Black Keys?
Yeah.
Oh.
They're not Gaga or Bruce big.
No.
No, but as far as rock and roll goes, they're probably top three.
There's only three bands in rock and roll.
Why are they doing that, though? They don't need
to. The Stones?
Yeah.
To sell pay-per-views.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Sell pay-per-views.
I'm more likely
to buy
now,
a
what is she
going to
sing? Is she going to sing a Stone song?
I would
sing something that sounds like Madonna.
Oh, they're coming out with them?
Yeah. It's a Stones concert, and Gaga will join them on stage.
You are such a Gaga fanboy.
It's called Little Monster.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a little monster too, Aunt.
Oh, God. Please.
I love Mother Monster.
Ah, God, no. Mother Monster.
Mother Monster's good. She understands me.
And you know he's promoting the pay-per-view.
Who?
Vince McMahon.
Wow.
It's his pay-per-view.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's a big one.
Has he ever ventured out into pay-per-views that weren't wrestling?
He's tried. He's done a couple boxing things that didn't work out.
Oh, of course. He did some football thing, too, that didn't work out.
Yeah, a lot of people credited that to the pre-show not being very good. I don't know if that had anything
true,
to do with
true,
it.
True.
Pre-show was a really needed work.
What a dud.
Yeah. Well, they didn't find the effort to get hosts.
Not at all.
Yeah.
That was called pay me, motherfucker.
Did you guys put a lot of effort into the pre-show?
No! And we told him, too. Wasn't going to be any effort. Oh, no.
No.
You don't want to watch it?
I want to see a minute of it because I don't remember it. There's some funny stuff here.
I try not to remember.
Why is my
volume
so
low? God.
Looks just like a beer, huh, Anthony? Yeah, just like one. We're going to watch tonight's game right here in Los Angeles to Las Vegas. We were at Giant Stadium for the
You had your jersey on. What was your team in the XFL?
Who the fuck cares?
Hold on, pause.
Just still have your jersey?
You know, to be on the field.
These
I think
fucking...
we're going to have a little friendly competition between you and I, Opie. See that football out there at the 20? Well, every game starts with this, and, you know, I saw it on TV. It seems, like, really easy, like anyone could do it. You didn't see the guy get his shoulder separated during it? Yeah. You want to bet something? I'll bet whatever you want.
I know is I was freezing.
All right.
Could you pause this, please? I want to go back over that moment of magic dialogue. I want to hear the chemistry. You want to bet? I want to bet something these two guys.
Magic dialogue.
Neither one of you knew what to bet.
It was obviously a crafted scene with. It's not like it was just improv on the spot.
No.
Yeah. Very well crafted.
This betting.
You want to play it again?
Yeah, it's riveting because it keeps you going. Like the big bet.
Boy,
okay.
You are fucking.
You know, to be on the field, I think we're going to have a little friendly competition between you and I, Opie. See that football out there at the 20? Well, every game starts with this, and, you know, I saw it on TV. It seems, like, really easy, like anyone could do it. You didn't see the guy get his shoulder separated during it? Yeah. You want to bet something? I'll bet whatever you want. All right, first beer.
First beer. I didn't hear that.
First beer?
Now
look at him go.
I didn't know I'd be running in my work boots.
They're both running for the football. Opie trips and Anthony falls on it.
Oh, boy.
Is that really how the game started?
Opie's going to retrieve the tee.
Opie's running out onto the tee.
Careful. It seems somebody already took it. What happened out there, Ope? There's no tee. Somebody else seems to have taken it. You look like an ass.
Are you Jesse the Body Ventura?
No, I'm the body, but I'm Bob the Body Golick.
Oh, boy.
Wasn't he on Saved by the Bell?
Yeah, he was. The new class. Or no, the college years.
Oh, the fan moments.
All right.
It's like an episode of Oz.
It sure is.
We were on the field for a while with the big football players, and it was very dangerous. Nothing compared to being here.
Oh, yeah. Because what's going to happen, Anthony?
Yeah, all we wanted was to come down, maybe get a beer. And now it's...
All right, enough. I can't take me
anymore.
Why,
you guys can't even move?
Thank you.
Yeah, right.
I was just speaking with one of the sideline reporters who asked the football player something. Very exciting.
Anthony.
Yes, sir.
We're just interviewing the sideline reporter.
That was sarcasm, by the way.
He had just talked to one of the men from the Bolts that made a very key play, Opie. That's what he said. Very exciting talking to him after he talked to someone.
One of the men from the Bolts.
Yeah.
Who made a very key play, Opie.
Yeah.
Vince McMahon.
Wow.
It's an honor now. Now, in some way, shape, or form, I knew this would happen. We would end up employed in some way, shape, or form with something.
Some way, shape, or form twice.
One day, and maybe you don't know this yet.
Yes.
One day you're actually going to be in the ring with tights on, flying around, taking what we call bumps.
Taking what we call
like,
bumps.
My bedroom, man. Even the tights, Ben.
These are the fans of the XFL.
How many? Eight of them?
We also heard you... You handpicked us for the job to host XFL Game Day.
Without question, because if there are two individuals who are eminently qualified to host this show, it's Opie and Anthony.
Now,
Did you mean jealous? This Anne yeah. Anatomy?
Jealous?
Or
yes.
There's some confusion.
Dude, there's no reason to ask that, but yes. We can make fun of you. We can make fun of you all day. I'm very jealous.
But look, I'm fucking rapping with Vince McMahon.
Of course.
Right,
and he's like, knows who you are.
You see what how sick is that?
He's like, yes, I did pick you, Anthony.
Exactly.
So fucking suck on that.
Obviously, yeah. You haven't seen the show.
It's that bad.
No, it's so good. That I think it might even go over your head. No, why would we do that?
Okay, just double check.
You know, it's so good, I don't even think you need to watch it.
Yeah.
It's that
runs
good.
Itself. It you know, runs itself.
Just like the XFL.
Right. Okay.
Thank you guys
right.
very much.
All
thank
right.
you, Vince.
Take it easy, Vince.
A little bit of fun we
oh,
had.
Oh, God.
Cool, right back to the bar.
Cool. You guys can drink on the job?
It's crazy.
We really are nuts.
We're just lunatics.
It would be obvious that
look at the camera work. So it's got to move.
Right here, you pushed me. I go flying by the ball.
Yeah.
And you end up with the ball right there. Who has it at the end? Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
You cheated.
Yeah, but you got the first beer, boy.
I'm a man of my word. Here's your beer.
Thank you, Opie.
It's a TV beer, and you're drinking it with the straw, but there you go. Anthony, tonight's game, it's the Los Angeles Extreme taking on Las Vegas. The Outlaws in Las Vegas. Let's check in with Bruce with a preview.
Great. poor Bruce.
Did Vince McMahon ever yell at you?
No.
That would make me really jealous if you and Opie got pulled into a meeting and Vince.
You stink!
Told you what dog shit you were.
What a terrible show! You are awful! You're fucking up my whole program! You're fired!
Nothing better than stories of Vince McMahon.
Would you like Vince to yell at you?
Oh my God, I'd be in paradise. If he was critiquing my performance on something.
And it wasn't good?
And it wasn't good. Fuck. I'd be like, oh my God, I'm here.
All right, people. Anthony, who won the game? No one knows. Oh boy. Now, you were a little bit like, wow, look at that. They're talking to Vince McMahon.
Yep. And he said, Opie and Anthony,
right.
That he picked you guys.
Now, you've spoken with a lot of wrestlers.
Yes.
Wrestlers.
Sure.
And even a few that you know on a first-name basis.
Yeah, I know some of them.
Have you ever spoken to Vince?
Yeah, I've interviewed him twice briefly. Like at press events, though.
Did he know you?
No, he doesn't know me.
All right. Got that over on
you. He doesn't know me.
I got that over you.
It's not the same context.
No, it's
as
not.
As you. You made me very jealous.
That was cool. That was an awful fucking show. There was no rhyme or reason to it. Like, no one knew what the fuck was going on.
I performed for that audience, though. I remember it was early in my days with Opie and Anthony, and I performed at that. When I see you guys with that awful background, with, like, a black background with a weird little stars in it.
Yes.
It was a weird...
At the restaurant?
Yeah, it was at the Hard Rock.
WWF.
It was called
New York.
The WWF.
Oh, that's
New York
what it was. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Same thing though. It's ended up being a Hard Rock. Now.
I remember doing stand up. Me, Voss. I had been going in for a little while. The crowd kind of knew who I was.
Yeah.
But that's got to be 2000.
Oh God.
Or was it 2001?
I was sad when they shut it down.
I think it was pre-firing.
Oh, and I know it was.
So that's 2000, right?
2002 was firing.
Okay.
August 2002.
Yeah. Well, thank God it didn't last long. There was just nothing. They told us, you guys don't have to worry about a thing. You just show up. We'll take care of everything. And then we showed up and like, no one was taking care of anything.
And they're just like, what do you guys
want to do here? You're supposed to have like it all scripted out and tell us where to be. And
you guys just be you. We hired you for you. So just give us Opie and Anthony.
There was one episode that they... taped and then they came back to edit it and they realized that some guy up front was making jerk off motions to us as we were on stage and he was in front row and doing that, you know, forced perspective thing of jerking us off. And they couldn't use any of the long shots. They had to use all tight shots that day.
It must look so
the guy
awkward.
Was so pissed. He was so fucking pissed. Yeah, it was quite awful.
Yeah, that's the one. That right there. What do you guys, can you put that up? What are they doing there?
Oh, no. We're just
game bait. That was the debut.
With the fan.
Telling everybody what a great show it's going to be.
A little bit about
you're lying?
This program, XFL Game Day. This is a pregame show the way it's supposed to be.
Oh.
It's a party.
That's look at me. It's a party.
This is not your father's pregame show. Oh. This is XFL Game Day.
Oh. All right.
And,
All right.
Some upcoming
I know.
Let's leave it. Let's leave it.
We're going to head out to the field for a few of the games. Don't expect us to get too close to the players. But we're going to take in the locker rooms. We're going to take you behind the scenes. We're going to take you into the stands to see the crowd and the beautiful cheerleaders of the XFL.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I can't watch this. We're
going to
do a little
of
that tonight.
Wait, rewind that. I missed that line.
I can't watch this. Why are you doing this
to me? It's actually not that bad.
It's terrible.
We're going to take you behind the scenes. We're going to take you into the stands to see the crowd and the beautiful cheerleaders of the XFL.
Oh, my God, no.
That's right, Anthony. We're going to get up close and personal with the XFL cheerleaders. We're going to do a little of that tonight. What a crowd, man. What a crowd.
Love yeah.
Great crowd.
Anthony, we should also tell everyone joining us
I tell you.
For game day. We got Bruce Beck and Rusty Tillman, the coach of the New York, New Jersey Hitmen.
Rusty Tillman.
Anthony, great to be with you and a pleasure to be joined by Rusty Tillman.
I remember that day, too. I mean, I remember fucking...
it was difficult.
That crowd was great, man.
I'm sure there's more.
Would you just fucking... No.
Why? You want to get close with the cheerleaders?
I can't. Did you think it was the next big thing in football?
Well, it was Smash Mouth football the way it's supposed to be played. So I assumed.
You were like,
Vince McMahon at the helm, it couldn't fail. That's what I assumed.
You and Opie were thinking, well, if we were at the NFL from the beginning, imagine how well we'd be doing today.
Exactly. Oh, my God. Anthony, you sound cool. Oh, you fucking assholes. Oh, the Hitman's girls.
Wait, no.
Yeah.
You thought it was the players, Ant.
That sounded very WWF right there.
Oh, no. Oh,
the players' buses are rocking.
Wait, no, no.
Beautiful. Now, this is what football's all about.
Okay, I was being sarcastic. I was being sarcastic.
Obviously, the cheerleaders are here, and we're going to meet them next. It's XFL game day.
Yeah, I look so comfortable on stage. I'm trying to...
The cheerleaders, by the way, are just dressed like fucking a bunch of moms.
Yeah.
What the fuck? You're right.
They're walking from one end to the other.
None of them have sexy outfits on. They're walking across the stage. Those fucking whores, they're not even stopping. You're not meeting them.
Oh, God, stop. Please stop.
We're going to watch the cheerleaders walk by us in regular clothes and wave.
Chip, you like the guitar?
Fucking heavy. I'd have fucked all those girls.
They needed, what Chip they needed hosted. Was a fucking crowd.
You guys have been waiting for.
They it's wished they could get the crowd
York,
without
New
us.
New Jersey Hitmen cheerleaders.
Oh, you are meeting them, okay.
Here they are. Now they're going to dance. Oh, my God. This is so
bad. I will tell you, with the crowd going crazy like that, it doesn't look... nearly as awful as it could. Like, you know,
especially since instead of XFL, they were chanting ONA.
I know, right?
They're just your radio fans.
But it was a statement how big the show is. I mean,
they were just
massive audience there.
A bunch of dumb fucking.
Yeah, but look at that.
Mutants.
Look at that.
Yeah. ONA had a stronger audience than the XFL did.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, here's Opie. Ladies
of the Hitmen.
There you guys are.
Ladies, let's get to know them one on one. Ladies.
She's getting the crowd hyped up by...
What's up, New York?
All right.
I am Envy. Are you all right? I love you too, baby.
She's holding on to Anthony's arm.
Yeah. She's not quite my type.
I can't wait to be right up in the middle, whining y'all all the way up.
All right, sister. Sit down, sister.
All right, what's your name?
Hi, I'm Yoon, and I'm here to cheer for you, New York.
You're not you. You're me.
Carla, and you know I came to New York City just to cheer for the Hitmen. What's up?
Why didn't they bring a white woman over to me, for God's sake?
Wands. What's your name?
Hi, my name's Jillian, and XFL rocks, baby!
Those are all like Chip, these girls.
I'm HD, I'm from New York City, and
Hitmen. Can I get a white chick?
Wait, pause this. How about one of them just goes, hi, I'm Brenda. I grew up in a small town. And I'm here today. They'll have to yell something rock and roll.
Yes.
Oh, no.
I'm Leslie Nicole, and I'm from Brooklyn, New York.
Oh, Brooklyn was in the hizzy.
Hey.
Oh, there we go.
I'm Caroline. I'm from New York City, and we're here to show you some booty.
But she says Boutte.
Boutte.
And what's your name?
Hi, I'm Ma'am, and we are going to rock your world.
Whoa.
Pause, by the way. Who was it that said Twatte? It was
The girl
Brittany
who
was, Andrews.
Was that who it was?
Yeah.
Twatte.
Twatte. She's really annoying.
Why are we watching the introduction of every cheerleader?
Yeah,
come on now. Enough of this.
I like your haircut.
I've had it. Oh, please.
I know.
This is fucking all
Opie,
right.
Opie looks 14. He looks like he's fucking 14 years old.
I like that the cheerleaders
fucked up.
Are all like, XFL rules. There hasn't been one game yet.
Yeah.
How do you know if the hitmen are good?
Like everybody's got hitman loyalty already.
Yeah. The New York, New Jersey hitmen. Two states.
Yeah. Fucking horrendous.
That's hilarious. Yeah, where's the team loyalty coming
from? Can it be? There's no one. They haven't played yet.
Not only does the team not exist, the league doesn't exist yet. There hasn't been a game. All you've seen is footballs and logos.
And Bruce Beck and Rusty
Bruce
Tillman
Beck.
Talking about how great the team is.
And Opie and Anthony.
They would get all they would do the technical aspect of the show. Bruce Beck and Rusty Tillman would talk about the players and the plays and, you know, all that, the color commentary.
Because they don't want to lose that audience of hardcore football fans.
We were the rock and roll part of the XFL.
Yeah.
You know, because it was fucking, it was football with an attitude.
Fuck yeah.
They were the football part. We were the attitude.
Fuck yeah.
You like the XFL, Chip?
Fuck yeah. Oh, it was fucking hot. I was a big Hitman fan, because I'm a Hitman.
Yeah, do you like the Hitman?
Fuck yeah. Smash Mouth, cocksucker. You fucking awful.
Oh, it's just an abomination. Oh,
the New York, New Jersey hitmen. The tri-state area birds. Oh, shut up.
I think I might have every XFL game on tape.
Yeah, why wouldn't you? Because you can't get them anywhere on DVD or whatever.
Yeah,
I think I have a box of all the XFL games.
Get rid of your dumb
because
tapes.
Because it was related to Vince McMahon and wrestling.
I was the only one watching by the end.
Oh, the Wikipedia. Yeah. Founded 2000, ceased 2001.
Wow, it only lasted a year,
huh?
That was it.
It literally, it went from like, the first game had really good ratings, I remember. It was a Saturday night, and it had like amazing ratings.
We thought we were fucking riding it to the stars.
Within 2 weeks, the games had, I remember the articles. At that time, it was the lowest ratings in television history.
Yes.
But like, it was the lowest rated program in all of television history.
What was the problem with it? Like, was it that no one could get new team loyalty, you think?
It's just hard to create a sports league.
Yeah, because they were subpar players, because the good players were in the NFL.
Very
the rules
subpar.
Didn't make sense.
And no one wanted to watch that much football. I mean, it was...
Yeah, you just finished.
The season was right after the NFL season. And after the Super Bowl, you're like, oh, I'm going to watch some fucking not even college players.
Yeah.
It was just horrible.
I'm trying to start a Jax League or Tiddlywinks.
Although he hate me went on to the NFL.
Who? Did he?
He hate me.
Who's that?
He was the big star in XFL. They all got to have, they got to wear weird things on the back of their jerseys.
They didn't necessarily have to put their name on the back of the jersey. They could put like weird things.
So
he hate me.
See, there's certain things when you do that, you think you're being cool and crazy, but you're compromising a weird, consistent integrity in the game. Like it makes it clownish and people don't like it.
Right.
Right.
Well, they tried to bring some of the aspects of wrestling to football.
Jesse Ventura was doing play-by-play for the football.
Oh, man.
It was like, they worked on Saturday night's main event. He's not a football guy, though.
He's got to make a tackle here.
Well, obviously, someone stole the ball.
What?
It's a conspiracy.
Okay.
Jesse, why?
It was... But after that first game with the huge ratings... I mean, I was picturing us, you know, well, it's been 20 years. This is our 20th year here at XFL game day.
Did you guys think that, you know, if we do well with this XFL thing, they may end up moving us over to Monday Night Raw, and we're going to be on TV regularly.
I thought that was, the next big step right there. We were in the middle of it.
Really? Were you fucking packing up and moving to Dorktown?
No, we were already there, believe me.
No, that could have been great. I mean, the crowds were very impressive that showed up.
Oh, yes. That's the only reason we were there. Because they knew we could fill the fucking place up with people. Mm-hmm. The only reason. I remember after like the third episode or something like that was we got brought up to the office and was like, oh, yeah, this, Yeah, they're just scrapping the whole thing.
The whole pregame?
Yeah. It's like, oh.
Did they replace you guys?
No, they just went with no pregame.
Yeah, they eliminated the pregame.
Was it doing well in the ratings?
No.
It was actually the only thing doing worse than the XFL.
Yes, yes. No one was tuning in for the pregame. No. Before the game, no one tuned in for.
I wish Vince McMahon had given you that speech, though.
Yeah,
I just told you how shitty a job you guys have done.
It's ranked number 2 on ESPN's list of biggest flops in sports.
What?
What's number 1?
The XFL.
Oh, yeah.
It's number 1.
The pregame itself. Opie and Anthony's
pregame show.
The USFL?
Ryan Leaf.
Wow. Is he done?
Yeah.
What years did he supposedly play?
98, 2001.
And then wasn't he the big guy at one point?
Well, yeah, he was like
the big draft.
Yeah.
And what happened?
He just didn't work out. It happens all the time.
He was a bigger flop than the XFL, though.
That's what ESPN says.
I don't buy that.
Did he get
XFL
paid?
Was a giant fuck.
I'm sure he got paid. Yeah.
Ryan Leaf, what's he doing now?
Let's see.
Is he out of football for good, you think?
Yes, I'm pretty sure. His last comeback was in 2002 with the Cowboys, and they released him.
Wow.
He was supposed to be like a big thing?
Yeah.
I didn't know.
I remember the name. I don't remember who he was playing for.
In 2009, he was indicted on burglary and controlled substance charges.
Oh, boy.
In March, he was arrested on burglary, theft, and drug charges. 4 days later, he was arrested again on burglary, theft, and criminal possession of dangerous drugs.
So is he stealing to support a drug habit?
Probably, yeah.
Didn't he get a big contract or not?
In June, he was sentenced to 7 years.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit. Wow, he's doing well, I guess.
It's always sad to me when people have so much potential or it looks like things are going to be so amazing. And then they just... Who was the big draft that year? It was
get
him
off the drugs.
And let's someone else. I know the name Ryan Leaf, and I don't follow draft picks.
Peyton Manning.
Wow.
Who's he?
Didn't Ryan Leaf go first?
Yes.
Oh, man.
He's the number one pick?
No.
Oh.
I'm
wow,
sorry.
That's a...
Get your shit straight, Travis.
That's a fall from grace right
that
there,
dude,
huh?
Man.
Jeez. You got to watch them drugs, people. You got to get off the drugs.
3 years in the NFL. Maybe he didn't.
Yeah,
have
Manning went first, and then Leaf went second.
What was his contract? Can you see?
Yeah, 4 years, $31 million.
Wow. Holy shit!
So guaranteed $11 million signing bonus.
So he blew that money.
Probably. Yeah.
Oh my God, he blew the money and ended up in fucking prison
doing burglaries for drugs.
Like he should be able to like. Wow, my NFL career didn't work out, but at least I got this $11 million.
Yeah, dude, I haven't burned through $11 million in my life.
$11 million?
No.
In 10 years?
I haven't burned through $11,000 in my life.
Oh, you.
I've never seen
you got your whole life in front of yourself.
I did at
don't
one point.
Don't you? You're saying you did? You don't anymore?
No, wow.
You don't consider yourself, what are you, 40 now?
What's no.
No?
I'm approaching 30.
Oh, 30. Rapidly, right?
Yeah.
You're barreling into 30.
9 months.
Mm.
So what do you want to talk about with Zimmerman? I'm guessing it's the same thing that I thought. Was it
yes,
about the lawsuit?
Yes, the lawsuit against NBC.
Good.
For making him look like fucking a racist and a criminal. This guy's... I keep saying justice for Trayvon, for the love of God. How about justice for the case? Like, you want to find... out the truth and what happened here.
People who are, it's hard to kind of like, by default, it feels like if you're supporting Zimmerman, and I don't mean you, I mean anybody, it feels like you're against Trayvon, but it's not the case. Because he really didn't do anything wrong. He was just an unarmed guy walking home who
scroll down on that page. He didn't, down, I mean up.
And Zimmerman was one of these annoying wannabe cop guys.
Look at his nose. Jesus, did he get fucking punched?
Yeah. He was one of these annoying wannabe cop guys.
Yeah, you think?
Yeah, without a doubt.
It's neighborhood watch.
Yeah, but you're supposed to just see something, you call the cops.
He did.
You don't get paid for that.
He did.
But he was walking around. Like, I'm not saying he deserved to get beat up, but that's what one of those wannabe cop guys does.
If you were in the situation where he was seeing somebody walking around that looked exactly like people that robbed the fucking neighborhood, you're gonna keep an eye on him.
Sure.
You're gonna see what happens until the cops get there. Just keeping an eye on him. Not following him, not fucking, you know, harassing him.
Right.
And then Trayvon apparently starts punching him in the fucking face. So, whatever. Whatever.
Yeah. I don't know. Who knows what happened with that confrontation?
Exactly. You don't know. It'll come out in the trial, I guess, as much as can come out through witnesses and stuff and physical evidence. But NBC edited some audio.
Terribly.
To make it sound like he was a racist. And they're suing. Thank God. Good.
And NBC is disputing the accusations.
How? They fired the guy that did it.
They said there was no intent to portray Mr. Zimmerman unfairly.
What lie?
Well,
you know, whatever.
Let someone decide that when they hear the fucking recordings.
I don't know how they're going to win that.
They're not. They're going to settle. Because anyone that doubts the media bias as far as, like, I was talking to Keith and this comedian named Mike, a black comic from Brooklyn, about this Trayvon thing.
Yeah.
And about the editing of the fucking... It's like, it's not about black people don't get punished. They get punished. They go to jail. It's not.
Of course.
But it's the way the fucking press portrays it. Like, why would they do that? What's their motivation behind doing that? Trying to make Zimmerman seem whiter than he is. Trying to make it look like it was purely about he hated blacks. Like, what the fuck was the advantage to that?
Viewers, they want people to watch to be to make it compelling. It's a lot more compelling a story if it's a white guy that killed an unarmed black child unjustly.
Yeah.
So they want to make and oh, if he's a racist, oh, if we got some evidence that he's a racist, that's exactly it. It's just to get people to watch.
So they really are. It's just a self-serving thing by the
Absolutely.
Press. Absolutely. The whole race thing is literally just to boost ratings.
Boost ratings because they know it's one of those issues that just fucking oof. People will jump all over it.
They're creating the news because then blacks get upset and start to pro. Because if they showed all race case and report, like, maybe this guy Zimmerman is racially biased. Like, do I think that he would have followed me or Travis the same way? No, I do not think so. He made a judgment, a stereotype judgment, and he was wrong. He made a wrong judgment, and things got out of hand. So if you show it like every time something happens black on white and you talk about the race and then you show white on black and talk about it, it loses its effect.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you're talking about it all the time.
Uh-huh.
If you only talk about the white on black, it's still... Because if it's black on white people aren't going to sit outside and fucking protest.
Well,
that's not going to be... News is not going to cover that.
I don't know why there isn't more of an outrage on black on white. Why isn't there more of a fucking outrage?
One of the reasons is the press doesn't report it that way.
A fuck of a lot more.
Because the press doesn't report it that way. They always report it like the robbery
that
is the motive.
It's just a crime.
Like they're just animals who are grabbing for what's theirs.
Right.
Like they can't seem to think that black people have the same angry or ugly thought process as white people. It's a way of making them less intellectual.
Terrible. I mean, we could go right into that other story of that woman on the elevator. She's a fucking 85-year-old woman. She's white. They have a security footage of her going into her lobby. There's a large black gentleman in the lobby, follows her in. And you can tell she's kind of, he's trying to talk to her. She's kind of very leery about the whole thing. But she gets into the elevator. Now, this is the part where I was like, what the fuck? This is what political correctness has done. And I think this ties in to the Zimmerman angle because when he saw Trayvon walking down the street, it's the same line as seeing this guy by the elevator. You look at it, you identify a black guy in a hoodie walking around your neighborhood that has been robbed by black guys in hoodies. You're going to be suspicious.
I understand that. And I understand that I stereotype too.
So this woman absolutely should not have gotten in that elevator with that black guy standing there. Because she's racist? No. Because you got to play the odds. It's not in her best interest to step into that fucking elevator with that guy right there.
Because let me see the Travis.
She should have stayed in the fucking lobby or walked out the front door and found somebody else to assist her. But no, this guy has no business being there.
Because her instinct. Oh, you know why? Here's what happens. The guy is sitting in the chair.
Right.
The woman gets onto the elevator.
Right.
The guy sees her getting on the elevator. He jumps up, walks towards the elevator, and opens it, and she tries to walk out. Like, so she actually...
She did try to walk out.
She did try to walk out. She didn't think he was going to get on with her. I can see why she got on, because...
Oh, man.
He sits down.
She sat down. Oh, no. Wait. What the hell happened there?
No, maybe she didn't think he was going to follow her on.
Right. That must have been somebody else getting in the elevator when he was sitting.
Oh, okay. And she sees this guy trying to get on. She tries to get off.
Wham.
And this fucking animal just pushes her against the thing, leans over, takes her stuff.
Takes her shit. took a wedding ring too.
Yeah, of course.
Which
of course
she was coming back from a nursing home where her dying husband was.
It's on life support.
Yeah, on life support. And this savage takes her fucking wedding ring. And she even asked him. I guess it's in the clip.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, let's listen to what she said. She was interviewed.
Yvonne Sherwell Demokopoulos returned to the lobby of the West 13th Street apartment where she became the victim of the unthinkable.
It happened so fast that I, of course, you land there and you're terrified.
The absolutely sickening crime was caught on surveillance video. Watch closely as this brute follows Yvonne inside the building late Saturday night. The longtime tenant appears skeptical of the unknown man from the start, and as they quarreled inside the elevator, he violently pushes her to the ground, her legs flailing in shock. The suspect not only took cash and her purse, but one particular item the unwitting victim, whose husband is on life support, desperately begged to keep.
And of course, here's my husband who is dying, and he took my Greek wedding ring. And I asked him, I didn't think he was going to menace me, so I asked him. I said, please give me my wedding ring back.
But he didn't and took off. Here's a closer shot of the guy police are looking for. A black male around 35 years old, between 6 feet and 6 foot 3. You can see he was seen wearing a sweatshirt and a brown winter hat.
He looked very, very at ease, and he was just waving for his prey.
His prey. Yeah, I mean, it's... There's such a fucking problem there that no one wants to address.
And what she should have done, like, here's the thing. Because you get these weird instincts about people, and it's not always right, and it's, but a lot of times it is. Like, if there was a big black guy standing there in a suit, or just, you know, a guy looked like Ruben Studdard, you probably wouldn't get that fear if he was just this regular guy. It's a weird thing.
That guy looked like a thug.
He looked like a fucking problem.
Thug.
And his energy was probably thug energy.
Yes.
He probably didn't come off nice, and her instinct probably picked it up immediately, and she didn't listen to herself.
People don't listen to their first instincts because they don't want to come off or even think of themselves as having any kind of racial bias.
Yep.
You gotta fucking think like that.
She should have said, I'm waiting for somebody here.
Oh, look, a hoodie. Wow, is he there in support of Trayvon wearing a hoodie? It's the fucking uniform of the thug.
Yeah.
The fucking hoodie is a thug uniform.
Yep.
Yes, not on you, Travis.
On Travis, you look like a fucking lesbian walking through an all-male bar.
If you're a black male and you want to walk around with a hoodie on, you're going to be fucking profiled. You're going to be. Sorry. Take it up with all the fucking black males that are ravaging people that are wearing hoodies.
Well,
Take it up with your fucking community. Don't blame white people that are following you around stores and fucking giving you shit and profiling you at every turn. Because you know what? That's the profile. You can't fucking get away from it.
How about a hoodie footy? Now, if you have a hoodie footy pajamas,
hoodie footy,
they'll profile you as a cutie, as a sweet boy.
It's fucking disgusting. The amount of black on white crime also is just, God, it's astounding how much it happens.
It happens a lot, and it's not reported. What bothers me is just that the bias is, the fact that it happens isn't reported as such.
No.
Like, it's like, just report it. You know what the motive is there.
Right.
He's a weak white target, and they went after him for that. So just say that. But they never will. They just won't. And we have to accept that they're never going to do it.
FBI hate crime stats came out yesterday for 2011, and it's predominantly black victims and white perpetrators.
Of course.
Of hate crimes. And you'd read it and think like, wow, that's terrible. No. Because they never do it the other way around.
No, they report it differently. And you know what? Fuck the police departments for reporting it that way, too.
Exactly.
That's coming from police department reports because they don't want their stats to be high, or they're told to keep it down, or whatever. But that they're guilty of reporting it that way, too. It's not just the press.
It really is infuriating because every crime that's perpetrated against a black person by a white person is instantly looked at as a hate crime. But black against white...
Say black against white twice?
I said no. White against black is always a hate crime, no matter what the circumstance is. Black against white is rarely ever a hate crime. They just look at it like, nah, this is just a robbery. Nah, this is just an assault. No matter what.
Or it's in a pepper.
Ah, that's a good one.
No, it's not.
and black on white crime far exceeds white on black crime.
So how much is Zimmerman?
And black
asking?
On black crime is fucking crazy. Crazy high. Outnumbers everything.
How much is Zimmerman asking for?
$18 billion gazillion trillion.
He has a legit lawsuit. That was a terribly edited. Yes. Who the fuck is the news to edit any 911 call?
Right?
How dare they?
Yeah, completely inaccurate.
God, they're fucking pigs, man. You can't trust any of them.
It twisted around the meaning of that whole 911 call.
Yeah, it wasn't like they cut out a couple of minutes of silence while somebody was running or just crazy screaming. They did that with motive.
They changed the whole essence of the call.
Now, they're going to say they didn't, but anybody, we have the common understanding of fucking English. Anyone listening to that knows that they changed that meaning.
Yes, absolutely. I was very flattered last night on Twitter. I noticed that Zimmerman's brother has a Twitter, and he's always tweeting things in defense of his brother and taking on some of these black activists that are tweeting things about his brother. And I went to follow him and realized he was already following me.
Wow.
I know.
You mean the brother of the fucking, of the wannabe cop who fucking couldn't keep his gun in his pocket? There's a fan. Wow. Doesn't get any better than that, does it?
I was flattered.
The brother of he's a celebrity.
The brother of fucking Zimmerman.
Your brother shot a guy with Skittles.
Yes. I was like, wow. He's following me. So I.
I guess that's what both of them do then. They just follow people. Get it?
Literally. And
there it is. He's following me. There he is. What is it? R. Zimmerman Jr. Junior. Yeah.
By the way, Andy Ray raises a great point about how full of shit I am. Because I was saying you shouldn't follow, and he goes, this from the guy following the New York bus for 20 minutes.
Oh, right. Look at you.
So, what you're right.
Oh, I wish the bus driver got out and punched you in the nose.
Yeah, because he thought I was trying to bother him.
No, I was just following the bus. It had its light on. The light on.
I'm an idiot.
You thought it was stolen. You're adorable.
Yes, I did. It said stolen bus, call police.
You are adorable.
Boy, did you.
I did, but I couldn't believe they weren't sending anybody.
You're a fucking rat.
You were outraged.
Fucking rat.
Yes, I was trying to help everybody.
You were trying to do your civic duty.
Yes, I was putting myself at risk for all of you.
Was that what you were doing?
Mm-hmm.
That's ridiculous.
And there was a fucking shooting right in front of our old building.
Yes!
A block away. It was like a fucking mob shoot. It was a black
dude.
But it was like a mafia-style shooting.
Yeah, this guy was from L.A., the victim, apparently. Oh. He was in New York from L.A., which is weird because that even makes it a little strange.
East Coast, West Coast.
Something going on.
Yeah.
He was walking down the street. And this black guy just comes kind of jogging up behind him, pulls a gun out, instantly just shoots him right in the back of the head. That guy drops dead and, then walks a few more steps, hops into a waiting car and drives off. That is definitely some type of business being tended
to. I'm hearing drug-related.
Drug-related. Well, you could assume that looking at the principles involved, that there might be an issue with drug-related violence.
That scene in American Gangster when Denzel just shoots him in broad daylight.
Broad daylight, right there on the street. That's what that shit was, yo.
Yeah.
Yeah. He had a beef.
But he got into a car on 57th Street, and they drove down 7th. Well, you better fucking do that at the right time of day.
Oh, man.
It's fucking 4:30, and the suspect leaped into a car. Police caught them an hour later when they had moved 20 feet.
Yeah, they're not even chasing. They're three cars apart with the lights going. Woo, woo, woo. Wow, that's a lot of fucking. Is that all blood?
Yes.
That guy bled out from the head pretty thoroughly.
Yeah, I think that's what happens when you get shot in the head.
In the head at point blank with a big gun.
Imagine walking down the street and then being dead. You didn't even realize that your life was ending.
Like, I wonder if he ever saw it coming,
Probably not.
Hit him right in the back of the head.
You just are alive 1 minute, and then all of a sudden you're dead.
I imagine that's for you sometimes.
Why?
Oh,
why?
Know, man. Funny.
It's not funny.
That's something, too, that you just can't defend against.
Get no, how could
you? Unless you're just looking around, constantly jumping around.
You could wear those mirrored sunglasses that they put in spy kits with the mirrors on the back.
Oh, fucking nice.
Like you buy from, like, backs of comic books.
Right, or, and that way you could always watch your back.
Fuck that shit. I'm going for some fucking True Lies cigarette pack glasses. We have the cigarette pack with the camera in it, and you put the glasses on, and then you just hold the cigarette pack at your side and look behind you. Then you put it on the sink in the bathroom. You take a piss, and when the guys pull the gun out, you...
Gotcha. Pew, pew. Gotcha.
Yeah. Could do that, too.
That seems like a specific scenario, though.
Oh, hell yeah. Want to take a little break?
Yeah, I want to go to the bathroom, and we have a good week. We were supposed to have Snooker today, but I guess his wife's not feeling well, so he's going to be next week.
Yeah.
And we have Quentin Tarantino on Thursday.
Quentin Tarantino.
And my new CD comes out today. It was taped in 2007 in Boston. I taped two together. It's No Baby For You. I love this set. I was going to release it 2 years ago, but I didn't. So.
Oh, silly you,
but it's,
Jimmy.
It's good, and it holds up pretty well. So if you like it, go on iTunes and get it. I hope you do.
Quentin's promoting Django.
Are you going to see that? I'm seeing that tomorrow night.
Django.
I want to see that tomorrow.
Django. The D's silent.
What?
Looks great.
Never heard of that. I hear the word niggers used 300 times. Literally, 300 times.
Wow, it's like you driving home.
Oh, boy. Any outrage about that?
Not yet.
Any outrage?
I mean, Roland
said... Spike Lee?
Roland said 300 times. I mean, that literally means every 30 seconds the word has to be used.
All right.
I don't know for sure.
And?
There won't be any, because Jamie Foxx is the star, and like...
That's true. Yeah. Now, but
if there's any outrage, he'll just...
If you remember, Spike Lee got pissed off at Tarantino for putting that word into Pulp Fiction too much. And Reservoir Dogs.
Tarantino doesn't care.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah, well, and he was referring to a whole storage facility of them.
Well, true that. But
that's some of the best dialogue.
That's hilarious. Ever. Gentlemen, let's not start sucking each other's dicks quite yet, gentlemen. Like when they are done and everything is cool.
We're all going to suck
then
some dicks.
Some dicks are going to get sucked as Jimmy makes the coffee. That gourmet shit. Yeah, that fucking shit.
When Bonnie
is
goes to the store, she buys shit.
She buys shit. Jewels. Okay, jewels.
We come back, we talk about the radio people.
Oh, yes. The Aussies.
There's more radio people stuff.
The ad bag. Get a blooming onion and strike. That guy is the fucking worst. It's so annoying. The Outback commercial accent guy. Yeah, we'll talk about that after these words.
I was driving home and I was behind a bus. You know, like the bus has an automatic sign. 911, call police. I call 911.
911, what is the emergency?
I'm on 10th Avenue northbound and I'm behind a bus and the sign says call 911.
I thought it was a stolen bus. I didn't know what was happening. There could have been hostages. I mean, we all saw that Keanu Reeves movie. I'm on the phone with the 911 and this fucking dummy is, where are you now? I said, I'm northbound on 47th Street on 10th Avenue. Okay, you're on, now where are you now? I said, 48th Street. Where are you now? 49th Street. That you...
Instead of heading which way, sir?
Northbound. The only way you can go on 10th Avenue.
We're so irritated with these dummies. So we make the left on 57th Street. We go down to 11th Avenue. I go, look, he's making a left on 11th Avenue. It's a yellow light, so the bus slows down and then shoots through the light and leaves me at the red light. I knew that the bus did that on purpose. I'm like, this guy knows I'm behind him. Now we're going southbound again, so I call back.
No, always emergency.
So I just called and no one is doing anything. I'm following a stolen bus, I think.
No one is doing it. How long does it take to get a squad car and fucking 11th Avenue? So I pull up next to it and it's really dark on the bus and I just see there's a black dude. I'm on the phone. I'm like, I'm looking at the guy and he's just a black dude, but he's not dressed like a bus driver. And I know that he's stealing this bus. I'm northbound now and he's behind me and they're like, what street? I'm like,
I was passing 40th Street.
The woman was like, where was he before?
10th and 11th, but then he came down 11th and now we went up 10th.
Okay.
He's probably going to turn it off because you're going to lose him. Follow
sir,
his fucking
keep
side.
Saying 10th and 11th, but 10th and 11th are in parallel. What street and 11th?
I know. He was on 10th and then he went down 11th.
So then I was just like, fuck this shit. And I drive away and he pulls away slowly and starts to drive. And I'm like, you know what?
Forget it. You know what?
Thank you.
He just turned off.
Okay.
We lost him. And he probably turned into the bus depot.
SiriusXM. The Opie and Anthony Show.
Wow. What is this?
Oh, don't try to your dream.
Fucking Pepsi gave Beyonce $50 million deal.
Jesus
Christ!
Righteous bucks.
But is there any, like, is anyone going to drink fucking stupid Pepsi because of Beyonce? Like, are people that dumb? They care what celebrity soda?
I guess they never look at it like that. I think it's just ball, like just shove Pepsi in people's faces.
Oh, imaging? Okay.
Yeah. It does strengthen the brand, probably, to have a giant celebrity.
Does it?
I mean, it helped Pepsi when Michael Jackson was their guy.
Yeah.
Britney Spears was the Pepsi girl.
Marty McFly.
Marty McFly.
He liked Pepsi. He always ordered it in the little diner, in the mall shop.
And none of it makes Pepsi not suck.
Pepsi free. I'll have a Pepsi free. You gotta pay, pal.
Pepsi stinks.
Then I'll take a tab. Can't have a tab.
No. I like Pepsi.
Oh, it's Diet Pepsi is fucking horrendous.
Diet anything stinks.
Diet Coke is great soda.
No, it's not.
In a can? You guys are fucking... It is.
Coke Zero. I could drink Coke Zero.
That's all I'm saying.
I cannot drink Coke Zilch. and Diet 7-Up might be passable.
Yeah.
There's something about a cola that's diet that just doesn't fucking... Mm-mm.
See, Diet Coke, I prefer to Coke. Coke is too sugary and it makes my mouth dry.
Oh, I like my mouth dry.
Yeah. I don't like it. But I can't drink regular Coke. It fucking irritates me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll have Diet Dr. Pepper if I'm at my aunt's house or something.
Will ya?
Why? Yeah. That bitch only have Diet Dr. Pepper?
That's right. It tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
Yeah.
I hate your aunt.
Are you a pepper?
I am a pepper.
Wouldn't you like to be a pepper, too?
Mm-hmm.
You don't remember that commercial because you're a little kid.
No, I know the ironic T-shirts that they sell now.
Yeah.
And I know what the reference is, too. But I certainly didn't see the commercial.
It was the guy from American Werewolf in London. And
right.
He would dance around. And he was also the drunk guy from the Seinfeld episode. The alcoholic guy.
Oh.
That was him, too. And he'd dance around. David Naughton. And he'd go, drink Dr. Pepper. Oh, that's it. Yeah. I used to be alone in a crowd. Ooh. But now you look around these days. There seems to be a Dr. Pepper craze. I'm a pepper, he's a pepper, she's a pepper. We're a pepper. Wouldn't you like to be a pepper too?
Not anymore. I'm a
pepper, he's a pepper, she's a pepper.
No. If you drink Dr.
Pepper, you're a pepper too. Yeah.
I can't believe these were like real commercials at one point.
Dude, it was
this
insane.
Is how they advertise things.
The old commercials were like these song and dance numbers. There was a commercial for Coke.
That's one of the best commercials ever.
The Coke one?
One of the best commercials ever.
I mean, the song became a song that was on the fucking radio.
I'd like to give the world a Coke.
Yes.
The original version.
It was I like to teach the world to sing. I like to teach the world. Why is this still playing?
I know. Yeah. Find the Coke song.
I want to hear the Coke.
I like to build the world around. Da 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 da. Furnish it
with love. Furnish it with love. Oh, this. Listen how groovy.
This is groovy. There's a groove to it.
This is old school.
Very Christmassy.
Yeah? Remind you of Christmas?
Is it the bells?
Yeah.
And it was a bunch of people in a field. With like candlelight or some shit, and they all had little bottles of Coke.
What was this, like 71 or 70? Is this the original era?
Yeah. I don't. Early 70s, like 70, 71.
Yeah, this is like.
Coke is terrible for the world. It's just making people fat and diabetic.
They can't rhyme very easily to that, so I guess they left that out of the song.
You'll have to call a medic.
You're fat and diabetic.
I'd like to chop off the world's left leg.
What is that? Yeah.
Oh.
A news story?
Oh, okay. Ooh. Travis brought in a CD of a news story.
I like a good news story to sink
good
my
morning,
teeth
America
into.
Good Morning America reports on prank phone calls in the radio business.
Oh, let's hear that.
Ah, yes. Let's get into the whole debacle down in Australia. Seems the radio duo is off the air now.
Yeah, right? Why wouldn't they be? Sure, it's their
they
fault.
They did that little prank phone call. They called the hospital that that bitch was in. What the fuck's her name? Yeah, exactly.
Kate Middleton.
Kate Middleton.
The Duchess.
The Duchess of what?
Cambridge.
Yeah. And apparently the woman that put the call through to the nurse couldn't take the pressure and offed herself. And now, for some reason, that is the responsibility of the radio station and the radio personality.
Instead of concentrating on one of two things, either this woman's obvious depression, mental illness, and selfishness to leave her kids, or a culture that is so obsessed with not making mistakes that you commit suicide when you make what was basically just an honest mistake.
Very dishonorable. Well, it's English, but
that's the problem, is the culture that doesn't allow a mistake without a, you know.
And insulting the royal family in England, there are some people that just look at that royal family like fucking...
royalty.
That is royalty, yes, like royalty.
Are you royalty? You suck dicks.
Lawrence, that sounds like royalty.
I love the fact that he goes, are you royalty? Do you suck dicks? Like, that's the next question. Are you royalty? Do you suck dicks? You're either one or the other. You're either a prince or a cocksucker. They're suck dicks. Best question. There's nobody I meet that I don't want to ask that to aggressively.
Oh, is that hilarious?
What a great interview question.
Yes.
So you're on Homeland. Yes, I am. They're suck dicks.
What? Yeah. Shit. Yeah. So the woman killed herself, and they did an interview. We heard it yesterday. An interview with the DJs. And boy, were they busted up.
Yeah.
Boy, were they busted up. A little fucking sad about the whole thing. Then they pulled him off the air. And now there's all kinds of news reports I'm hearing about what could possibly happen. What are the repercussions? Can they sue? It's like, who's going to sue? Do you think their intention in any way, shape, or form was to hurt anybody goofy call?
They can sue. You can always sue.
And I heard someone say something about wrongful death.
Well, like, I've heard... I've read that they didn't get the okay to air this. So
a minute, they said
they
got the okay.
Yeah,
they like said it went through channels.
Maybe that's why they were saying that.
Oh, maybe.
Well, they're saying, you know, we tried to call the hospital 5 times to talk to somebody about airing this, and then for some reason they just aired it anyway. The hospital saying nobody ever called us at all. Or tried to.
Oh, so maybe the station is doing damage control, and maybe these guys didn't really. There's one point that was raised by the hospital, which, because I was like, what the fuck? Why do they care? But they raised, and I wish I could find it before we do this story, because I thought it was a point that made me understand the hospital, at least their point of view. Sorry, guys.
She's in hospital. They don't say the hospital.
She's in hospital.
She's in hospital. He's on holiday. On holiday? What does that even mean? Crazy English.
They're saying that...
I'm at university.
Yes, I'm on holiday. And then you see like a woman's singer laying there going, get off me. They did not contact... The hospital said they did not contact senior management or its press office in advance despite claims. And they're saying they're extremely surprised by that statement. You know, and they said that, to be honest, no one here is really apportioning blame at the presenters. They are clearly kids out of their depth. The hospital made a good point here. They said, but there are serious questions to be asked of station management and about why they thought it appropriate to prank call a hospital where there are extremely sick people and to broadcast what were private medical details about one of its patients.
Oh, boy.
Like, when you look at it that way, it's like, all right, I understand why the hospital is pissed off. Because that really, even though it for us fucked the royal family, it is private medical details about a patient. Like, all right.
Yes.
That's actually a good point.
Well, the penis is going to be removed tomorrow.
Imagine if the hospital was pranking him back. Yes. We're having a black cock tattoo taken off his buttocks.
So, what is the news doing? Some kind of a
yeah,
radio talking pranks?
Some of the biggest prank calls.
Oh.
Well, back at 7:42, with more on the fallout from that royal hoax by Australian DJs, American shock jocks have been going over the line for years with outrageous stunts pulled live on the air. So does this tragic episode mark the end of their funny business? ABC's Lizzie Davis has the story.
Oh, hello there. Could I please speak to Kate, please, my granddaughter?
The Australian DJs who made this prank call have gone radio silent, their show now canceled, and the station announcing a company-wide suspension of prank calls after the nurse who initially answered their call later apparently committed suicide.
Right, it's B96.
Radio DJ Jay Nice on B96 in Chicago has a regular prank segment on his show.
Oh,
entertainers try to use real-life everyday circumstances and try to find humor in it.
He says his station has no intentions of pulling the plug on prank calls, and they don't need to based on U.S. law, where such calls only become problematic when it can be claimed it was foreseeable the act would cause damage or injury.
Hello, this is Sarah. How are you?
Sarah Palin was famously pranked while she was running for vice president by a notorious Montreal-based comedy duo pretending to be then-French president Nicolas Sarkozy.
That's funny.
You know, I see you as a president one day, you too.
Maybe in 8 years.
prank caller even managed to make his way through security to speak to Tony Blair while he was still prime minister.
Hello, Tony.
Yeah.
Hello there, it's William Hague.
It's quite a good imitation.
But it was no laughing matter in 1998 when Opie and Anthony, DJs from a Boston radio station, were fired for telling listeners on April Fool's Day the mayor had died in a car accident.
He was in a horrible car crash today.
While the Australian DJ show has been terminated, it's not clear yet if they will be.
She's given us real information.
The same joke they initially laughed at is now the reason for their tears. Lindsay Davis, ABC News, New York.
They love it. Oh, what a great piece. Wow, that's a great piece you put together there. Oh, my God.
Boston radio duo.
Yes, Boston radio duo. Yeah, I was listening to that going, ooh, who are these guys?
Yeah, they sound fun.
Oh, they didn't mention it was no laughing matter, and after you got fired, you went on to the biggest success of your career.
Exactly.
And I got fired again.
Yes. But it was no laughing matter. Why wasn't it? Of course it was. It was ridiculous. It wasn't even an authentic, like, death.
I used to do mean prank calls. Me and my buddy Tyler, I would just call Indian people out of the phone book.
Oh, no.
But this is way before Star 69. And I would just go, like, the guy, I remember some guy's name was something Patel. And I'd be like, hey, is this Mr. Patel?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to get you, boy. I'm going to kill you. Get out of town. He'd go, who is this? Who's calling me? I'd go, and he would know I had his name from the phone book, so I'd say his name. I'm going, we don't need you around here. I'm going to kill you. It was like these things that could get you in so much trouble.
Yes.
It's horrible.
Those are like threats based on, you know, race and things.
I was really high and drunk one time, and I may have prank called my school and said there was a bomb somewhere.
Oh, my God, Jimmy.
It's not a prank. That's a bomb threat.
That's a bomb threat. Yeah. When does a prank become a bomb
threat?
But
I may have said something like, and if you think this is a joke, then start laughing. And hung up while me and my stone friends were around giggling, and then I heard they evacuated the school. What's the statute of limitation on that? That's like 1985.
Yeah, I think you're all right.
And by the way, if you think this is a joke, then start laughing.
Yeah, what I think that was the mean? Line. That's what a crazy person would say.
No, it doesn't mean anything.
Yeah. No.
Like, instead of acting, laugh.
If you think that's a joke, start laughing.
I used to call all these fucking... We would go to my buddy Scott's house, and I would get fucked up. And I used to call these nuns that would help like wayward runaways. And I was just always talking about being raped. I was getting like raped and stuff. And I needed help. But my prank calls weren't clever or funny. They were just disgusting and mean.
Yeah.
Aw. Hi. Hello. I'm going to kill you. Click.
It was just threats.
Yeah, I was just a jerk.
You are a jerk.
Well, the time I called the bomb threat to the White House from the library.
What?
I was probably 12, 13 years old from the North Brunswick Public Library. I might not have got through to the White House. I think I just called the operator and I told her to put me through to the White House. Because I was going to bomb this or something.
It's hilarious.
So, I was young. I didn't know it was bad. I thought it'd be a big laugh.
Oh, Jimmy. What the hell was your thought process then?
I don't know.
Weren't even any jokes. You were just calling up and threatening people.
Yeah.
I
wish I could remember all of them. They were not
clever.
Can
you imagine what the operator thought when a 12-year-old kid is asking to be transferred to the White House?
Give me the White House. Come on. Yeah, from the North Brunswick Public Library. Fucking dork city.
I was simple with the prank calls, like just, you know, call up random numbers. A lot of random. When you didn't have to, you know, there was a time, let me tell you about a little more about history.
Yeah.
Young Sam. There was a time where if you were calling a number in the same area code as yourself, you did not have to dial the area code.
Really?
So if I'm calling a friend, I would just dial, you know, 261. 5437, something like that, instead of putting the area code in front.
Well, I mean, now it's just, you just click the name.
Oh, right.
Who even has phone numbers anymore?
This is true.
You just click the name in your phone.
You just click the name in your phone.
Right.
But you used to have to actually, you didn't have to dial in that. So you could dial random calls very quickly for prank phone calls.
You could just dial seven numbers.
Right. You'd use the first three from your neighborhood or some friend's neighborhood or something like that nearby, and then you just dial random four numbers.
And somebody would answer.
Yeah. But if you wanted to get creative, then you would look in the phone book, because then you'd have the name, and be able to, like you said, you know, you have his name. Hello, Mrs. Johnson. Why, yes, that's me. Now you could get a little personal.
When I was a freshman in college, me and my buddy.
My buddy and I.
Oh, you're right.
Oh.
My buddy and I sat in my dorm room looking up people in the college directory with sitcom last names.
Oh, shit.
Calling and asking for sitcom characters.
That's hilarious.
And my phone ran out of battery, so he started using his phone. And then somebody filed a harassment charge against him on his phone. Because obviously, it's like 2002. People will call our ID.
Oh.
He got in so much trouble. I didn't take
harassment
any blame.
Charges?
Yeah, because you can't, you know, you can't look up. You can't look up the name Winslow and then call them up with a black woman's voice and say, "You're Harriet, where's Carl?"
That's pretty good.
You know?
That's a good one.
So.
Yeah, there was no Star 69. People like back then would have to just hope that you stop. Remember heavy breathing? People would call you and just breathe. Fuck you.
Yeah, yeah.
Fuck you.
That's so hopeless. They would... The way you just said that, you just have to hope that they stopped calling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I really hope this person stops pranking.
Change your
me.
Number.
I'll take it off the hook for a while. I'll take the phone off the hook. And then you do that, you'd have to get past the point where the dial tone. And then we go, beep, 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 beep. And then we just go silent after a while. But then you couldn't get phone calls from anyone else.
No, because there was no call waiting or anything.
No. Nothing worse than like trying to call someone in the busy signal. Remember the busy signal that would be like for an hour?
Yeah, yeah.
An hour and a half, you're like, oh, the guy's mom's on the phone.
An emergency breakthrough. You remember emergency breakthroughs?
You'd make an emergency. Hi, operator, could you get an emergency breakthrough?
You'd call for an emergency breakthrough. And the operator would say, so-and-so wants an emergency breakthrough.
It's like, who's on the fucking phone that long?
With the very beginning of like AOL, you used to call people's house and it'd be busy for hours because they were on the internet.
Right.
Yeah.
14K.
I'm not talking about that.
No, this is way before, Sam.
I was talking about alive.
Moms used to spend so much time on the phone. People's, like, my mom, I know my friends' moms, they were constantly on the phone for hours
just
on end.
Jabbering like broads.
Exactly.
Fucking jabbering broads. Talk about nothing.
I knew it was going to be, like, I wasn't going to be able to use, and you weren't able to use the phone.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if mom was on the phone, you had no contact with your friends. You didn't know what was going on. So it sucked when, you know, the phone would ring and my mom would pick it up and be like, "Hello? Hey, how the hell are you?" I'm like, oh, fuck. This is going to be hours for a how the hell are you.
And they didn't want anything. It was just a long conversation.
They just would talk. Now you only make a phone call if you have the specific purpose to, like, I need you to do something, or, you know, you needed me to do something. Never just for conversation.
My friend Richie Jones used to call me every day in fourth grade, except he never wanted anything.
What a mo.
And I would always be like, okay, I got to go. And he'd be like, why do you have to go?
Yeah, he's like, fucking
what a
couples.
Needy guy.
I just don't want to be on the phone anymore.
Oh, he's needy.
Yeah. My mom didn't let me go to his house because he lived in a low income, you know.
He was from lower stock
area, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Richie June. I would talk to a couple of my buddies growing up, and you just spent hours on the phone. Like, it wasn't girlfriends, it was just you and your buddy yapping about nothing.
Just talk about nothing, school.
Falling asleep, chatting.
You fell asleep chatting with your guy friends?
Just buddies, yeah. He's talking to your friends.
Oh, very gay.
God. Is it gay?
That's very gay.
That is kind of gay.
Or just talkative.
Falling asleep with your buddy.
But it wasn't a love
whispering
thing.
Whispering sweet nothings in your ear.
No.
That's
very
ear.
Gay.
So you're in bed now?
Yeah, what are you doing? What are you wearing?
Do you wear pajamas or?
No, it wasn't. Touch yourself.
It wasn't that type of
touch
talk.
Yourself.
Can I tell you something, Jim?
Yeah.
I don't wear anything when I sleep.
No, we never had that.
I'm naked right now, Jimmy.
I'm naked, Jimmy.
I'm going to fall asleep.
Yeah.
Although we're saying,
are you asleep yet?
We're saying that Jim is gay for talking to his friends and falling asleep. This is the same guy who was blowing his friends when he was 7.
You know, but I'm denying. No, it's not. It's very,
very manly. I got in big trouble once with a girlfriend.
Oh, Richard?
Yes, Richard. Richard Schapinski. Yeah, I was having a tiff with a girlfriend. And back then, especially, boy, Anthony never got in tiffs with the girlfriends. It was always girlfriend mad, Anthony crying, please stop, and apologizing to,
really?
To girls.
Really? You were still in the crying phase.
Well, no, I wasn't really crying, but I was very sad.
Yeah.
I would never... I would never really get into it with a girlfriend, like yelling or even Like, I would be like, yes, I'm wrong, please love me.
Because you wanted to be liked so bad, you were afraid if you fought back, she wouldn't like you anymore.
She was
going to
fucking ditch me and fuck my friends.
Oh, which, no, that sounds terrible.
Which to me was like a fucking sentence worse than death.
Mm-hmm.
The old girlfriend fucking your friends thing. So we were discussing this on the phone, and I was laying down on the bed, talking on the phone, and we were having a very in-depth discussion. And the next thing I remember, I woke up to a silent phone like hours later. And I'm like, oh, no. Oh,
she's going to hate me.
And then I didn't know. I woke up at first, like, I didn't know what was going on. I'm like, wait a minute. Was I on the phone or something? Oh, my God, no, we were talking. Oh, shit, I didn't finish the conversation. She must have. And I'm just picturing her going, hello, hello, like I played the silent game with her. And
then you can't, you have to wait until the next day for closure.
It was pretty much, well,
text.
I had to call her back.
Sorry.
I had to call her back. And
wasn't it late?
It wasn't that late.
Oh, okay.
But, yeah, so it was what like happened? It was like 8 o'clock. She was so mad. She was yelling at me that how dare I fall asleep in the middle of such an important conversation. Oh, was she pissed? I'm sorry. Oh, no, sweetie, I'm sorry.
Were you
I'm
always like the groveling, apologizing?
Yes.
Did it work out?
No, she fucked my friend. I swear. Fucking cunt. She fucking went off with Frank.
I'll never fall asleep on the phone with you.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, you fucker.
Justin Stengel just texted me and said when he was in high school, a heavy breather called and his mom answered.
Oh.
And his dad was traveling, so his mom thought it was his dad just messing around, and she was talking to him for 5 minutes while he was jerking off. And then she remembered his dad was on the plane, so she hung up immediately.
Holy
so she's just
shit.
Talking to him. He's jerking off. Then she's like, oh, shit, his plane hasn't landed.
Oh,
let me break Justin's fucking bubble. What happened was his mother was having phone sex, and when Justin walked in and said, Mommy, who are you talking to? She went, oh, it's your father. She built that excuse.
Yes.
What she was doing was she probably was standing by the counter, and she had a fucking roller, and as she was talking, she was probably grinding her cunt into the roller.
Oh, my God.
No, his mom. I mean with pants on. Oh. No, all due respect. I love Justin. But she was probably grinding her crotch, I should say, into the end of the fucking, what do you call, is that what he called the roller?
The rolling pin.
She was just grinding her fucking clit and groin, talking to this stranger. Because her favorite book was A Stranger Calls Me.
Yeah.
She would read it, and she had it dog-eared for all the sexy parts. Ooh, I'm reading A Stranger Calls Me.
And then she would rub kitchen utensils on herself?
On her vagina, yeah.
You think they use the rolling pin women?
Yeah, or the ice cream scooper. Like, if she was at the table, she would probably use the bottom side of the ice cream scooper over her slacks.
I didn't know.
While the Stengel were eating soup. I'm sorry, Justin.
The whole Stengel family.
Yeah, they had no idea. Like, where's the ice cream scooper? And then mom would sheepishly pull it out from under the table.
We want dessert.
Yeah.
I bet a woman wearing tight pants would like a nice whisk. You take the whisk and just in your lap, like you're whisking eggs to scramble them.
Whipping up some butter.
Yes.
And you hand it to your boy and he licks the beaters. Licks the egg beaters. There's a fucking hair on it. And leg sweat.
Like a thick meringue. Ooh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, you never want to think about your mom talking a guy through a jerk.
No.
She was fucking talking a guy through a jerk.
Just jacking off.
Oh, no.
Yeah, anything. It was very difficult to get a good jerk in when you lived at home like that. Not just because it was hard to get time alone, but you never wanted to equate what you were doing with the rest of your family, you know? Like, cause it's always like, oh, mom's got to do my laundry. So, you know, where's the jizz going? It's going in the sheet or somewhere. Yeah, I don't know. Or you're jerking off in your room and, like, she's got to go in there and clean.
Mm.
It's just a weird situation with that. And then I used to steal her Cosmo magazines. I used to steal her Cosmo to jack off to it. They had Cosmo Tells All in the back, and it was always a nude shot.
Really?
Yeah, some nude picture. Some of them were kind of, like, blurry, but other ones were like, yeah, it's a nude shot.
Do you miss the days when you could just jerk off to a naked lady in Cosmo.
Oh, my God.
How nice was that?
Yes.
We were so less desensitized back then.
Oh, you could just fucking anything. Anything would be fucking stiff as a board right there. Any picture. Oh. Even reading Penthouse Forum. Oh. You're just reading Penthouse Forum. Imagining it in your mind. Now you need fucking three people, a donkey.
Yeah.
Kinds of shit going on. It's terrible.
When I used to steal magazines, whether it was Wii or Penthouse, Playboy was always corny. But yeah, I would steal them out of the fucking machine, the vending machine.
Wii was good.
But a good ass shot would make me fucking crazy. I could come to that in a second.
Yes.
And then you just get older and you're jaded and it doesn't do it anymore.
You've just seen so much shit. To jack off to something, boy, do you need a virtual three-ring circus of porno going on.
It's not exactly a treat to find something now.
No, you got a fucking computer keyboard set up like Emerson, Lake, and Palmer all around you. You're fucking working the mouse, the fucking touchpad, your dick. You're just trying to find something. No, I'm going to come to that. Wait, no, I'll get something better. I know there's something better just around the corner. 5 hours later, you're still edging.
Yeah. Penthouse Forum just looks like a blog now. Like, you can just read
look at that.
Everything.
It's hard to, you know, no one's going to go out and buy that when there's so much online.
Penthouse Forum, George.
You can go to, like, these big sites now that are these super sites of stories.
I'll take the sites.
Yeah. Meanwhile, I'm trying to jerk off, but I forgot I got the soup.
Yeah, being able to read something like that, like Penthouse Farm was fucking hot.
Yeah,
when I was younger and would read that, great shit. I love that.
Tug my
real.
Pud to it. No,
yeah, no, all these stories.
Oh,
are real. All
right.
Yeah, I mean, nobody's gonna write them in if they're not true. Yeah.
But there was the worst when you get a magazine,
fiction?
An issue that had no good stuff in it. Like,
no.
Sometimes you would just get one and there was nothing, nothing good. Like no good seduction stories.
Yeah.
I liked a good seduction story.
You'd need like, yeah, like some. Oh, what is this?
Yeah.
Oh, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Ooh, I never liked the bondage ones.
They stink.
Yeah.
She parted her legs, and I could see her underpants.
Yeah.
Not a fan of the bondage.
Even now.
No. Bondage stories do nothing for me.
I don't get it.
Nothing.
Unexpected encounters.
What?
I don't get it, the bondage. Like, I, there's some people, like, the idea of the tying and tickling is a weird one that does nothing for me.
Tickling?
Oh, yeah. Tickling's a big fetish.
Who does that?
Must be the helplessness.
Sounds stupid.
Can I ask if anybody out there would call in that has experienced a tickling fetish?
And don't just heavy breathe on the phone. We want to talk.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm serious. Like,
tickling's funny.
Some people
not,
like it. I don't get it.
It's not sexy.
I've seen it in video a little bit. I don't think I've ever known anybody who was into it, but it's just weird to me.
Dr. Steve checking in. I used to beat off to Betty and Veronica in the Archie comics, if nothing else was around.
Oh, yuck.
So much for the good old days.
Yeah, now it's fucking, he's lying. It was probably, he wanted to be in a threesome with Jughead and Big Ethel. Like, he would dream that Jughead would make him wear the crown while he sucked Jughead's cock and Big Ethel fucked him with a strap on. And then they could hear the Archie's band rehearsal through the wall.
Ah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good to be. Where's Mr. Lodge? I have a fetish for older gentlemen. I want Mr. Lodge to come in my face.
Mr. Lodge.
He wanted Mr. Lodge to fuck his shitter.
He says, thank God for the internet. Yes, the internet changed everything. When we were used to watch those, you old enough, Sam, to remember the scrolling pictures?
Yes.
Where you get AOL and bing, you've got mail.
Yeah.
You're like, ooh, someone sent me one. And you download it. It would take forever to download one picture.
I used to go into chat rooms and try to trade with people, but I wouldn't have anything, so I would just rip them off all
you
the
could
time.
Just
I did that too.
You would too.
Yeah.
You send first. Okay,
you send
at the same time.
Fucking asshole.
Goodbye.
Does chat rooms exist anymore on AOL or no?
Not really.
Are there AOL chat rooms?
Who would fucking go there? AOL was like internet training wheels. That's what it was. It was like, let's get everyone kind of into this to know what it's all about. And then after a while, you realize, wait a minute. If I'm hooked up to the internet, I can go and browse websites by myself.
Nobody knew what a browser was.
I don't need to stay in AOL.
Yeah. I forget. I was looking at something. Might have been like a a movie cover. So I don't remember what it was, but it had the old AOL keyword. Remember before anybody had a website?
Yes.
All the big companies had an AOL keyword.
AOL keyword. Because
they all had
Sony.
They all had AOL pages because you used to have to click through the AOL pages.
Yes.
And it was. I remember when I first started coming on the show, I would go to like AOL like profiles and stuff.
Yeah.
And I would like search Opie and Anthony, and whoever had like a girl that had Opie and Anthony in her profile, I would try to talk to.
Oh man!
Hi, I'm Desperate Jim.
Oh, that's hilarious! What a great way to get some chicks.
I don't know if I ever.
Did you ever score? No.
But look at how, in that last 10 years, how fucking different it is, man. It's amazing.
Totally.
I really don't watch my TV anymore. Like, I never thought that, if the iPad didn't have such cocksucker, typical pussy Mac volume, I would watch the iPad. I watch all, like, the whole fucking Boardwalk Empire watch on the iPad.
Yeah, yeah. You could absolutely do that. Looks great. You pop in your earphones, Jimmy.
It's not even loud. On a plane. Mac volume is so shitty with the iPad. Even on a plane, when I have Bose earphones and I can't hear it because of the engine noise.
It can't compete with the jet engine.
Yeah, it's annoying to me that they do that.
Yeah.
They want you to buy external speakers.
Yeah, absolutely. I used to go to the AOL, go in those rooms, and trade shit on like my brother's computer. It's like, fuck him, let him get in trouble.
I was 12.
Ooh.
So I used to.
You could have taken pictures of yourself and just sent them.
Now I know, like I could have made trade. Money. But no, I used to get kicked off AOL all the time, and they would call my dad because I always got terms of service warnings for pretending to be wrestlers.
What a jerk off.
Oh my God.
You have the worst Rebel story.
I know.
Who
would you try to be?
Goldust.
Were you ever Bob Backlund?
No.
And you were doing the knee walk around the AOL chat room?
No, I pretend I was Goldust.
What would you do?
Because my screen name was GDust1. And my profile, I filled out my profile, and it said, like, name Dustin. And I filled it out with, like, just things that alluding to me being Goldust.
How did they find out,
though? Well, the minute that you say that you are him,
yeah.
Somebody can just copy the conversation and send it to Terms of Service.
Why would they do that, though? Who cares?
I always got busted.
It's a bunch of rats running around there, huh?
And they would actually call, huh?
Yeah. I got kicked off AOL twice. I think I had 2 strikes.
Wow.
Because they're pretending to be Goldust.
Not for downloading porn.
No. What would you say is Goldust, though?
I would keep answering things. Like, they'd be like, are you really Goldust? Maybe. Why do you ask?
Oh, boom. God.
What and then eventually tick. I'd be like, yes, I am.
Yeah, I am.
Like, do you really hate Razor Ramon? Yeah, I can't stand the guy and blah, blah, blah.
You're
really
Sam
gay?
I am,
blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, I'm gay.
I'm the gayest.
Sam's an idiot. It's
embarrassing.
So what are you looking at chat rooms?
There were the rooms that used to just say, like, GIFs, and you'd go in there.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's where you traded.
Yeah, you can still do chat rooms. You got to download AIM, and I guess people are still on AIM.
And then when
I have AIM.
That's crazy.
I'm sure I have one, too. I mean, AOL. I would have to remember my...
I don't really use it, but
Are people still on AOL?
I have an AOL account. I still have Yellow Treats, but I don't use
you
it anymore.
Do?
Because I have some emails from years ago that I saved, but I got to go back through. I'm going to dump my AOL, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're cocksuckers. I got hacked, and they wouldn't help me unhack until I paid for the service because I was getting it for free.
Wow.
They're such scumbags.
What?
AOL are scumbags. I'm really glad they're taking a beating.
Isn't it free now? I mean, obviously, you pay for it.
It has to be. They're not doing anything.
No, there's no reason to. I remember people like, wait a minute, what do you want, AOL? I go, no, I just have Roadrunner service, you know, high speed internet. It's hooked Roadrunner. Up all the time. You don't even have to dial up.
What?
Because, but how do you like see stuff without AOL? I go, no, you just got to pop open a browser. You pop open Netscape.
A what?
Netscape, and it's great. What? But then where does it go? How do you get your mail? What do? It was weird. You left the fucking AOL compound.
Well, then you had to get like Hotmail or Yahoo Mail.
Yes.
I had ExciteMail.
I got Yahoo.
Is Hotmail still used? It is, right?
Yeah, a lot of people still use Hotmail.
Is
for
it still
some
big?
Reason.
Yeah. Gmail's big though.
Gmail's the best.
Gmail's, yeah.
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 It's the biggest. Yeah, you're still.
It is. I'm Yahoo, and I'm also me.
Oh yeah.
A lot of people have me.
You know,
what's
like
ME?
That.
For Mac?
Yeah.
I will never use iCloud.
But now it's iCloud.
They're fucking horrible. What was the last one before this that they did that was automatic syncing? Two or 3 years ago.
Yes.
I would lose
called?
Phone numbers all the time. It would wipe out like a month's worth of phone numbers. I fucking
really?
Hated it.
Yeah, it was the cloud.
It would sync three and four times the same numbers. It was so enraging.
I something.
iLife?
Was it I?
No.
iLife?
No, but I'll never use them again. People can hack your text messages. If you program it for your text messages to be saved through iCloud, people can hack that. So stupid.
I know with backing up shit, it's
backing
pretty
it up.
Fucking easy.
I back it up.
I know, because you get a new phone, and it just pulls the shit off of the cloud.
Yeah.
It comes from the cloud.
You don't need it. It's backing up through iTunes.
Yeah. You don't have to plug in anything.
You know what I don't like about that I can never figure out? You plug some shit in. You want to sync something. You want to back up your phone. And then it's like, all this will be erased. All this. If you continue with sync, this will be gone. I'm like, I don't want anything to be gone.
I hate calendar conflicts.
Yes. No, stop it. I did that inadvertently.
I never know what fucking calendar conflicts are, which one I should side with. Do you want to resolve this now? No. Some other day. I'll have a big calendar conflict party and have my friends over.
Certain contacts I have, it's listed four times.
Ah, Jesus Christ.
You sync it up. It's like, and it asks you if you want to, like, erase stuff. It's like, you know, it'll be eliminated from this computer if you sync with this. It's like, why can't I just fucking, don't give me any warnings that I'm going to lose some shit. You know?
Yeah. Like, yeah. But that's their idea of sync is like, it replaces everything.
Yeah.
You can't just be like, I just want what's on there, on here.
Right.
And then with everything else.
Yeah.
Want everything.
Right.
No.
Exactly. There's some, I don't know, I got some ideas.
You do?
Yeah.
About what?
Some ideas.
J'ai une idée.
Like apps and stuff.
I remember that from French, when I took French and fucking thing. J'ai une idée.
What's your idea?
Like, or I have an idea or something.
Oh.
It was when I had summer school for French. We had to do like a little play.
Yeah.
Maman, Jacques va en sauter. Mom, Jack insulted me.
Oh.
Maman. Sorry, guys.
Jacques insult to me.
I take the bus to summer school for France, for French.
You took summer school?
For high school French.
For high school French, you had to go to summer school?
So I could graduate or I could get out. Yeah, or so I could move on to the next grade.
I graduated in summer school.
Oh, no, I didn't graduate. It was this to get the senior year. Maman, Jacques ma insulté.
Wow.
Sorry.
You got a good inflection there, too.
Thank you. It's very
that hard. Must sound horrific to a French person.
I'm sorry, what were you saying?
For like certain apps. I was looking for one. You ever texting sometimes
sure.
You inadvertently text the wrong person, something like that.
Yeah.
Isn't there a button that you could do like that will have say like, are you sure you want to send this text? And you could program it to various like contacts.
I'm sure there will be
there
an
should
app
be
for
that.
That,
right? So that way you type the text in, and then you hit the button, and then, you know, if maybe your girlfriend or something, you don't want to fucking, you know, send something inadvertently to her.
I once sent a text that said, good morning, sweetie, to one of the publicists at WWE.
Uh-huh.
It was meant for Jess.
But how did you do that?
I've
done that a couple of times, but considering the odds of doing that are so astronomically low.
I don't know. I've sent, how are you doing, sweetie, to Ange. And Angela's like, well, not too bad. I'm here at your house.
Didn't you send? Didn't you send Than a text like years ago?
Yeah,
that
yeah.
That was meant for.
I think I was sexting Than.
Yeah. Oh my God, I did do that.
Yeah.
To Bob Saget.
No way.
It's one.
Would you misread faggot and you were going to send it to him?
Yeah, I thought it was you. No, I was. Dude, and Saget told the story in Montreal this year when he brought me on. I was sending it to a girl, and she would massage me, and she would go, I would go, like, I really could use a hand, which was meaning she was going to come over, and she had a fat pussy. She was sexy, and she was going to jerk me off.
Oh, man.
But that was our weird little code
Saget
word.
Would have done that, too, though.
But he probably would have. But I sent it to Bob Saget, and I'm like, oh, God, I meant that for a girl.
Oh, what did he say?
He laughed.
He must have thought it was hilarious.
Yeah, that's one of his favorite stories.
Yeah, yeah. It all depends on who gets it. But let's say you got your girlfriend or you got a multitude of, like, three chicks or something in your phone. You program the app or whatever it is to those three names. So not everybody. You don't have to verify for everybody, but just those names.
Do you sure you want to send this to
right.
Sam 5087?
It's like, yeah, and it gives you a heads up, and then you can hit yes.
There is an app for that, actually.
I've never seen it.
I'm creating it.
Well, it'd be a great one. But, no, I looked, believe me. There's Ask to Send, but that's on jailbroken phones.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm reading.
Yeah. I mean, why don't they have that? Great idea. Someone
companies like PayPal have it. Like, when I send money through the PayPal app, It'll say, like, are you sure you want to send?
Yes.
And I will say, yes, I am. Why would you ask me that? I'm
what
doing
are you
this.
PayPaling? That's crazy.
My wife.
Oh, sweet.
Why?
Because
I would do it for free if you... She's your wife, Travis. Do you know how much I'd love that marriage if she charged him every time?
That'd be great.
I would have so much respect for both of you.
That'd be great. Charge him.
PayPal's great, though.
Yeah, it is.
You get a PayPal, like, debit card, and, you know...
It really has come great. A long way as far as paying for shit online.
I don't use it for my bank account, though. Like, you have to set that up. But the way I use it is through a credit card. So I have a statement every month, and I know exactly what I send out.
Right.
I use it rarely, like online banking. But I hate America. I mean, Bank of America so much. Like, I try to use other methods. I just bored myself.
Bank of America. Yes, I understand. I don't like using my bank account for anything. Online, I don't do that.
No,
use credit card.
Yeah,
but I'm sure. I mean, what could they possibly do?
Well, banks are pretty good with because everything is so easy to track now.
Yeah,
banks, credit cards, they're all pretty good if you have a good history with them of giving your money back. Like I'm not worried about my bank account being raided and all of a sudden.
Right.
I know I didn't do it. I can defend that.
Yeah,
and there's not so much in it either.
Aw,
most of my money is tied up in investments.
Is it? Look at you. Tied up in investments.
I have a pittance here and a pittance
there.
You're
braggart. How's it doing this year? Do you get your statements and look at them?
I look at them. I look at my statements online.
Yes.
Fucking every week I go online. My fucking accountant told me. He goes, Jim, you watch your money better than anybody I work with.
Oh, Irish gentleman.
Yes, he is. He's Irish. Hey, Jim, keep your eye on your money, buddy.
Hey.
But I do. I fucking pay attention, man, because guys get ripped off by their accounts.
Oh, it's crazy.
Business managers. Everything has to go through me. I'm not saying never, but I'm going to be very fucking hard to steal from.
Those are crazy stories. Billy Joel got railed for a shitload of money.
By his brother-in-law, right?
We know the Dane Cook story.
Yeah, but Dane's guy was stealing physically, I think.
Was it? Like cash?
Yeah.
Like, fucking taking big stacks
and
of money.
And forgeries, I think. Like, that stuff that's hard to avoid.
Wow.
Because if somebody's forging shit, but you never give anybody else access like that.
Yeah.
Never.
No.
Everything. And no one has any power. They have power of attorney on one account, but I have to sign off for them to pull taxes out. But I have to approve it every time they do it. And they'll say, is it okay to do it for this? And it's just easier.
Yeah, I always get that thing. You got to sign this sheet so we can do this. I'm like, oh, okay, you know. But it's like every few months I get one of those sheets. But it's better than just giving them carte blanche stamp your name on shit, you know?
No way.
You never want that.
But I think being a radio guy or being a comic, it's like you don't deal as much with residuals. Like, musicians get so ripped off because they make so much money and then they have foreign distribution. And, hey, your thing was used in a commercial here and they sampled it here. There's like so many publishing rights and there's so many ways to get ripped off for these guys.
Yeah, so many ways to steal this. Because it's hard to keep an eye on everything.
Yeah, you got to have somebody you really... Like, I trust the guys that, like, you know, Kenny, I trust implicitly. He doesn't do that stuff for me, but
he's stupid to steal.
No, boy, Kenny could be fucking everybody. Watch someday they arrest Kenny, and he's got just a pile of gold from everybody. But Kenny, I trust with money. I think Kenny is very honest, because he worked with Dice, and he handled a lot more cash than I'll ever have, and he's an honest guy. Kenny's not a thief.
Yeah.
I trust Jonathan and Pete with my money. Bob even I trust financially. I don't think Bob's a thief.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because he's dealing with Opie and Anthony money, so he would probably steal from them first, because they make so much more.
I've dealt with Bob for so many years. It would be a great surprise. Let's just say if he was pulling any shenanigans, and Barry, our accountant, also. And I get the statements too.
I look at them.
Oh, look at that! We're doing a financial break.
It's good.
This is our financial break.
Well,
what are the futures looking like this morning? What are the Dow futures?
Well, I want to know what oranges are going to be like this year.
Oh.
So I'm doing a secret deal in a garage, trading places. The orange crop.
Yes. How ridiculous is that storyline?
Oh, Mr. Beeks. Oh,
that's it, Mr. Beeks.
Clarence Beeks. I have to tinkle.
I would take a little break. I like to call it a break a Rooney.
Oh, that's fucking cool.
It's hilarious, right?
Fuck yeah.
And
anything a Rooney is good.
I know. And we'll be right back a Rooney.
SiriusXM.
This is the Opie and Anthony Show.
Rap, 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 rap
Right. Green Day's so fucking cutting edge punk. Great stuff. You realize bands that were really big in the 90s and even into the 2000s kind of dropping off really quickly. Not really, not too much longevity into that new part of the thousands.
No.
Now it's all about all these bands. I don't even know who they are. I look at the MTV. I'm like, who are these bands on the MTV?
There are no bands on the MTV.
Yes, there are. They play them in fucking 20-second clips at the end of their programming.
In the credits?
In the credits. They play their bands. It's always some dumb-looking hipster chick and some guy with a big beard playing some music I could give a shit about.
You don't like a lot of the new music?
I don't like the new music. I like the Gangnam Style.
I like that,
I like
too.
The Gangnam Style.
Gangnam Style.
Oh. Is everyone officially totally fucking sick of this song?
Yes.
Fuck no.
What?
Oh, my God.
I'm doing my own version of it.
What are you doing, Chip?
Chippy style.
Chippy style? What's the gimmick? Do you dance around like the girls in this?
Just like that, yeah.
That didn't look like
could be very sexy. Sexy Satan.
What?
What is it, like a metal version?
Fuck yeah.
Oh wow.
Do it chippy style.
That sounds great.
Oh, you must be worried about offending people.
I don't give a fuck.
Wow. No, he don't give a fuck. Chip don't care.
Wow.
Chip don't
give a
shit.
Do you think that'll be a hit?
No. Of course not.
He don't give a shit.
Not even as a parody.
We need a girl in here. We have not had a fucking girl in this studio in how long?
No.
When's the last time we had a fucking chick in here?
We need a chicken.
Sick of male energy.
Oh, a chick in here. Oh, I thought it was a chicken.
Well, like a month or two ago?
Who?
A month or two.
We had those three Playboy girls.
Yeah, but...
I think Roland's working on some girls for next week, actually.
Like right now.
Right now?
Grab some broad off the street.
No, but we just like, literally have no fucking sexy energy in here ever.
You mean you want like a regular girl?
But it can't, or a fucking any chick. How about anything with a vagina? We never have that.
If you want to look back at the old days on OA photos, there's a gallery with Jimmy and Gina Lynn and a few other girls who wanted to be lesbians for the day.
I remember that. That was I didn't know that was Gina Lynn, where I'm sniffing her ass. There's that great picture of me sniffing.
Oh, it's yeah, right yeah. In there. I put the gallery
God,
up
I remember
last
that
night.
Sniff.
Yeah.
You making that face?
The sniffy face.
Sniffy face.
Yeah, I didn't realize that that was 2000, man. Gina Lynn has been around for a while.
Man.
Wanted to fuck her for 12 years. I've been striking
out.
Oh, wow. I know, like, it was so long ago.
I wish I wasn't in a relationship at the...
Like, you don't want to interview porn stars all the time, because it gets annoying and it gets...
Well,
but
yeah.
Once in a while, how about it?
I wouldn't even... Oh, there go the curtains. Like, you're not even showing anything. Oh, whatever. Oh, God, Sal.
It's because Sal's offended.
Yeah, yucky.
Yeah, Sal personally doesn't like looking
gross.
At girls.
Whenever he sees a pussy, he just yells, where is it?
What's going on there? Look at this.
Oh, my God.
Looking at pictures of just nude chicks.
So immature.
Look at that.
Wow, four asses lined up in thongs.
Oh, that's great.
We're just looking at old 2000 pictures from NEW.
Yeah. Oh,
they're showing their
that.
Pussies. Who is this one?
I don't know.
God, I like vaginas.
Oh, it's amazing.
I don't see enough of them. Do you know how long it's been since I've seen a vagina in person?
Really?
Yes.
How long, Jimmy?
While.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, God.
Who's showing me? Fucking nobody is showing me their vagina.
Don't you, like, go out on dates or something?
Do I? No. If I go out to eat, nothing happens. Not even a kiss.
Really?
No.
You don't get them back to your pad?
Oh, God, just a string of fucking duds.
Really?
Oh, I should be the mayor of Dud City. Of Strikeout City.
Dud City? What do you think you're
I
doing
I cannot
wrong?
Find anyone interested in me. Literally, it's been strikeout after strikeout after strikeout.
They're going out with you. That's like at least means something.
Nah, but I mean, like, I meet people weird, man. I can't find just a regular girl to go out who I kind of want. Everyone I meet has a boyfriend or a fucking cunty husband. This is why
you don't even fucking deal with them.
You dummies in your 30s. That's why I don't like you, because you're all taken.
You throw them to the wayside.
No.
And don't even return their fucking calls. or anything.
I don't know where to go to meet them. Wow, she's pretty. There's some pretty girls here.
I remember those.
Those four are hot.
Look at those asses lined up.
Yeah, I used to always be the one, because you and Opie were in relationships, so I'd be the one that got the lap dances and stuff.
God, yes.
I loved it. I loved that open air was fucking couldn't do anything, and I would just get my cock rubbed on.
I should have just been fucking everything.
Yeah, you kind of should have been.
Doing.
Look at that fucking nice big vag hanging down. So yeah, we need some sexy energy in here. Like we, every time a chick comes in, we don't have to beat them up and challenge them. Why don't we just talk to a fucking chick when she comes in?
I love just like talking to pretty girls.
Yeah.
Next week.
I get all smitten.
You did get to see Stalker Patty's vagina a couple
times. Oh, yeah, that was 2 weeks ago. What are you complaining about?
Look at the second one in from the left, dude, with the dark hair.
Yeah.
Wow.
She probably doesn't look that good anymore, though.
Oh, you don't think so?
12 years later? Those big tits hanging down. Years. Those look real.
And then who's that third one in?
Is that Gina Lind?
No, that's...
Oh, Gina's on the end.
Who is she? She looks familiar.
Yeah, Gina looks good,
Is it the blonde?
Yeah.
You called her Hot Wax Shannon?
Oh, I remember the name.
Oh, right.
What were their other names,
Z-Rock?
What were their names?
There were no other names.
Becca Tetley.
Becca?
Yes. Helen Myrtlechisk.
You love the name Helen.
Helen Myrtlechisk. It's a terrible...
How do you say that?
Imagine that. It has a couple letters with the double dots over them. What are the double dots called?
The
Jew haters.
Yes. Yeah, Helen Myrtlechisk is dancing tonight. Yeah, but we need that. Like, even if they're not eating each other's assholes, how about we get them in just to talk to them and talk about their pussies?
Oh. There is a fucking model for... this bra that is on TV. She's the hottest fucking thing in the world.
She in tomorrow?
Her name is Nina... Let's see.
Pinta Santa Maria?
Oh. Yes, Nina Pinta Santa Maria. Just put Nina model, whatever.
So ship
What's
comes
her name?
Up?
Oh.
Blackwell?
Nina, no. Nina... No. No, not Nina Beardsley. No.
Nina 99 Love Belongs.
No.
Nina Beardsley.
Nina Beardsley. No.
Won't you model my bra?
That could be her. What's her name? Yes, yes. Put her name in fucking Google images.
What am I, Sam? I know
what yes.
You don't know what
you're doing. Sam.
You're taking forever over there, apparently.
That's
you are.
True.
Look at this fucking... Now find... Go down and... I don't know. Find some fucking picture of her full body. Look. Dude, look at her!
Yeah, she's fucking pretty, man. Holy shit. I wouldn't mind smooching with her.
Oh, my God.
I'd kiss her. Let me see the top left one, the left one with her long neck. She's
oh, my God.
She has a nice kissable neck. Like, I would want to go out with Nina, go to dinner or something.
Yeah,
like,
yeah
with the,
right?
No, one below that.
What's her name? Nina?
She's a very pretty girl.
Nina Agdal?
Agdal.
I wouldn't mind kissing
Holy
her.
Holy shit.
Sit on my lap.
Check her out.
I want to be your guy friend. Hey, if you ever need to talk...
Why don't you tweet
you
her?
A real relationship.
She's got a tweeter. How many people are following her?
301. No. Oh, no, I'm sorry, 16,000.
That's it?
She's following 301.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to follow
her. Where's she from?
From, like, Denmark or something.
Oh, what the fuck am I going to do?
Fly her
here.
She's over there now.
Gingerbread house here. Eat this while I fuck in the shitter.
Look at,
24,000 likes on Facebook.
Oh, my God. She got any photos on Facebook?
She was in Sports Illustrated.
Yes, she was.
What? She
did quite a job.
Jim Norton quotes on Twitter this guy who has an awful apnea picture of me as the thing, and his name is Jim Norton. Well, he makes the quotes make me laugh because they're so just terrible, and his hashtags are funny. He's good.
Oh, what?
Why? No, just stupid. Like he quoted. Maman, Jacques Insulté, and then the hashtags are French Jimmy and Mom Jack Insulted Me. It's just terrible, funny hashtags.
She's Danish, by the way.
Is she really? Danish?
Oh, I want to bring her home for Belle.
shit.
Oh, that bitch.
Yeah, you got the old ice pick in the head.
Yeah.
What's the... Oh, have you seen the Twitter account... Modern Seinfeld.
Seinfeld today or something.
Yeah, I wanted it to be better than it was.
So did I.
But there were a couple.
There are some good ones.
Things. It's if the Seinfeld world there was still going on, what situations would they get in using modern technology like cell phones and
oh okay
and whatnot, and stuff.
What years was Seinfeld on? Like 90 to 99 or 2000 or 2001?
It was pretty much 90 to
2001.
2000.
Yeah, 90 to 98.
98?
Last That's episode it? Was 98.
98? Wow. I thought it was on more than that. And there was no fucking internet like in the beginning of that show.
No.
I was watching. Did I, oh, yeah, I think I told you this story. I was watching a comedian named John Mulaney, who's very funny.
Yeah.
And he does a really funny bit about getting spam email. And I was watching his act, and I'm as I'm just watching him, all the terms like spam, link, download, like these things, like I said to him, like, if you, this 10 years ago, nothing you just said would make sense. Like, it was amazing to me.
It would be alien language.
Yeah, like, and a certain word, like click and link were existed as other things, but like fucking download or fucking email, like all these weird words that you never.
Yeah.
I remember Florentine doing a joke when, like, you know, in the, when email was in the late 90s. No, I don't have email. The girl goes, email me. I go, how about I F-mail you? Fuck you. But like that, he was like, you know, kind of like, fuck email. And right, sick of hearing about it. But,
oh, got like it was going to be a fad.
But you can't comprehend life without it now.
Some of these are really funny.
What?
There are a few funny
ones. Some of the, I don't know, Jim probably wouldn't appreciate them because I can picture.
If you're a Seinfeld fan, yeah, then you can. Modern Seinfeld.
Yeah.
What, which one?
Elaine tries to learn the Gangnam Style dance. George gets creative on his LinkedIn profile.
See, come on. They couldn't do that because it wasn't out. It's crazy. Would Elaine
George's parents claim their house was destroyed by Sandy and move in with George. He discovers their house is fine and Sandy is a loud neighbor.
Ah, see? Look at that.
Jerry breaks up with his girlfriend because she Instagrams everything she eats.
That's funny. I would watch that episode.
That's something Jerry would break up with a girl for.
Jerry would break up with a girl for that.
I got one.
What do you got?
How about fucking Kramer slides in, but he slides into like a 2010 car or something.
Yeah, I don't really get it.
Culturally, it doesn't add anything new.
2010 car.
Banya steals jokes from Jerry's tweets. George lies on Foursquare to avoid his parents. Kramer leads the less popular Coney 2013 campaign.
That's perfect.
That's funny.
See, that's good.
Got them all doing something they would do.
Yeah.
With modern technology.
Fucking, how about one time Jerry's emailing somebody and he writes, who are these people? But he sends it to the people he's trying to talk about.
Oh, shit. Jerry.
It's good.
It's crazy. He would do that. I'm huge. I thought that was pretty funny. Funny Twitter thing.
Yeah,
but then they're like, I think he's running out already, which is kind of what happens with these things.
That's why you don't even bother following.
Do you still do you still follow Shit My Dad Says?
Oh yeah.
Is that still how long?
Is it?
How long was that show on? That Shatner
season.
One season.
Boy. Are you sure it was a full season?
No, it wasn't even a full season.
Was it terrible?
3.1 million followers.
How many?
3.1 million.
Oh, the people still. Is it still a funny?
There's literally a handful of episodes of the TV show.
I'm talking about the Twitter.
Yeah.
He tweets maybe once a month, maybe.
Oh, is it down from what it used to?
Yeah.
What's the last one?
I like babies just saying they live outside a host body and feed off it. That's a parasite. Yes, I could raise a tapeworm and love it.
Oof.
Boom. TV show.
But that was one of the
boom TV show.
But that was one of the first like novelty Twitter accounts.
Yeah.
Now, I want to start one. Stuff My Dad Says. Hey, get the salt. Fucking and just really non-interesting things. Hey, doors open. That's my new thing. Stuff My Dad Says.
That'd work.
Yeah. Hey, get the rolling pin.
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Ah!
Hey, my hat's got rain on it. Fucking just awful.
Ah!
shit. Oh. Stuff My Dad Says.
I guess people are attempting to ask me if they could post pictures of me. Can I post pictures of you from Saturday night at FAH? Yeah. What do you think? Unless you took them in the fucking bathroom.
Especially if you took them there, you should post them.
What do I care? Oh, no, I don't care if you asked. I can't carry on conversations with these people.
Are they dumb?
Do they know you're doing a radio show?
Sometimes, no. Sometimes they really think, like, I could just be...
You're just hanging?
Let me just hang out and talk. just going to have a little conversation. There's another thing, too. I get texts, and people are asking me stuff. Like, let's see. Here's Carlton. Tell me he's coming over to my house to pick up his cheesecake today. I'll write about your goddamn cheesecake.
Wait, why does he leave his cheesecake
there? I don't know, even know why he left his cheesecake
Who fucking carries a cheesecake with
them? I don't know.
I forgot my cheesecake.
Who stops off somewhere bringing the cheesecake to a third destination?
I haven't even asked, by the way. But there's a cheesecake in my refrigerator. It's been there since we left FH, went back to my house for a little get-together at my house. Everybody hung out, drank a few beers, had some fun, ate. And then I get a text the next day from Carlton saying, my cheesecake's in your fridge. Can you bring it to work tomorrow?
That's a Seinfeld today.
Right?
Did you say no?
I said, yeah, but then I forgot the cheesecake on Monday.
Why would you
yesterday.
Bring it?
And then why am I bringing it here? And then when is he coming to pick it up? And then we got to put his name in the security so we can pick up the cheesecake?
I'm here to pick up cheesecake.
Cheesecake? Cheesecake?
Can I tell you, if that was my house, when he got his cheesecake, he would go, why is there a helmet print in my cheesecake? There would be a cock print in that idiot's cheesecake.
So then today, he's fucking texting me about this cheesecake.
What time?
I'll be over at 2. Is 2 okay? I'll be at 2 today to pick up the cheesecake.
How about you fucking leave it out in the rain, then he can write a song about it.
I could go to MacArthur Park.
Yeah, someone left my cheesecake out in the rain next to a Nazi helmet.
Well, then I can't totally blow him off because he's the only black friend I have now. He's like the...
He's a nice guy, but...
He's the only black guy.
Is it a piece of cheesecake or a whole cake?
It's an entire cheesecake.
Why? Yeah, well, when he came over for his cheesecake... He would go, I'm picking up my cheesecake. Oh, it'll be on the front lawn upside down with a shoe print in the underside of the box. Here's your cheesecake, dummy.
He must really want this cheesecake.
For some reason. I don't even
There's probably a file in it. He's going to a jail.
Why would you bring the cheesecake to my house in the first place?
Did you buy it at F.H. Riley's?
Maybe he owns a factory that makes them.
Maybe he did. I should fucking put it on the table for him to get and just... Cheesecake Factory.
It's so bad.
I should put it on the table for him to get and just plop that little lawn jockey I have right in the middle of it. Here you go. Yeah. Here's your goddamn cheesecake.
Well, what I would do is I would put it in the driveway, and when he came over, he would say, why is your truck parked on my cheesecake? It would be bubbled out on both sides. You'd have to fucking scrape the side of the tire and fucking just fucking spoon it into his dumb mouth. How great would it be if you took a shit on his cheesecake and closed the box, and he got home, and his cheesecake had shit on it?
Just cut out a circle in the middle.
The big log. And just duty his cheesecake. he'd be so mad with a duty on his cheesecake. He'd have to eat around it.
Oh, my God. Enough about his cheesecake already. I've had to deal with this cheesecake all fucking weekend now, and it's Tuesday, and I'm still dealing with his cheesecake.
Oh, that's awful. What you want to do is fucking, like, video yourself cutting hot gassers on it for, like, 2 days. Like every time you have to fart.
It's melting.
You just gently put your ass cheeks right against the cake. You send him a tape called 40 Gassers on a Cheesecake. And he realized he's eating the cheesecake and his fucking farts all over it. Little boogies wiped on the cheesecake. Just cough on it.
Oh, my God.
Sneeze on his cheesecake a few times.
40 Gassers on a Cheesecake.
Cough on it.
I love that one.
Oh, a bunch of coughs. What would be worse than eating a cheesecake that someone coughed on all weekend?
Oh, my God.
I'd be so mad.
I wouldn't eat it. That'd be disgusting.
No, you show him after. After he's eaten a week later, you show him the tape.
Oh, my God,
You send the video that night while he's probably having a piece.
Eating the cheesecake.
Little tinkle on the cheesecake.
Tinkle?
Yeah, so just like a little sprinkle. Like, you shake your cock on the cheesecake.
And I noticed the top of the cheesecake is splitting now, too. So it must, it's like now, because the cheesecake's been there since Saturday. Saturday night, Sunday
Why
morning.
Why is it splitting?
Kinda.
Is it like a stock?
It like.
It's just a word.
I'm fading fast.
It doesn't work. No.
Are you overtired?
Oh, Jimmy.
Yes, I am.
I think it's like a, Like it contracts or something. It oh, it gets drier.
Well, it has to, otherwise it won't get paid.
Holy shit.
It's having a cheesecake, baby.
Oh, sorry. It must dry out, and then once the liquid goes away, it kind of pulls apart and cracks down the middle.
Yeah.
Well, 2 o'clock, this whole big story finally comes to a conclusion.
This cheesecake storyline finally wraps up.
Or when he got his cheesecake from my house, he would say, why is there what appears to be a big karate chop dent in my cheesecake?
Would you karate chop it?
All I want to do is open the box and go, hi-ya, and just chop into it.
Oh, my God.
And then just close the box, lick the cheesecake off my hand, and close his box. Good karate chop cheesecake. What could you put on it that would ruin it?
Well, I can think of plenty.
I think you've covered it with duty and boogers.
Duty and farts. Well, 40 gassers.
Or one of your old socks. Like you work out in a sock, and then when he opens his cheesecake box, it's just a sock laid over.
Athletic sock.
Or two of them, the shape of an X. The X marks the sock. Oh, it's terrible.
Oh, God. How about just use toilet paper?
Oh, my God. Wipe your ass and put on his cheesecake.
I could do that with, like, chocolate.
Yeah.
And just leave the tissue paper with chocolate streaks on it. On there and go, yeah, you figure out if it's real or not. His fucking cheesecake. I've had to stare at it every time I open that
fridge. It's in the kitchen?
Yeah, kitchen fridge.
Oh, my God.
So stupid, I don't know.
Cheesecake would be hurting by the time he got it from my house.
Done cheesecake. Right, we get it.
He loves that cheesecake.
Yeah.
So. But he knows that you're working. Why would he text you now?
Oh, that's what we were talking about. Yeah, I don't know. People just feel compelled to do that. Oh, there he is. Hey, what? Why do you have a cheesecake? Why is there even a cheesecake that you brought over my house just to take home? Cheesecake. No?
Is he answering?
Am I getting an answer?
No.
Got it from Mary.
Sam?
That's not my name.
Mary's cheesecake? Mary gave it to him at F.H. Riley's. Oh. Well, you should have taken that fucking cheesecake home, yo.
Because now there's farts and shit
now
and
there's
jizz
be
on it.
40 gassers on it. That sounds like a fucking a nice book.
Have Stephen Baldwin and Pam Anderson both been arrested for tax evasion? Can you look that up?
Wow.
They got arrested?
Well, I don't think Pamela Anderson was arrested. She just owes like $370,000.
Maybe
Stephen Baldwin was arrested.
Maybe Charlie Sheen could foot the bill.
How much does he owe?
I'll find out. Man.
Well, you know that Charlie Sheen gave Lindsay Lohan $100,000 for that? She apparently hasn't even texted him any kind of thank you or anything.
She's a fucking hateable...
Oh, totally.
...cunt of a person.
Totally.
Well, he said that she hasn't?
Yeah, I heard on the news today. She hasn't even acknowledged that he did it.
She's just a hateable fucking cunt.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's rare that I really actively root against someone like that as hard.
Uh-huh.
What a hateable bitch.
Lindsay Lohan hasn't thanked me for the $100,000.
Wow, well, Charlie was stupid to do that.
Totally.
It's like, I'm sure that you've given money to charity, but how about you give that money to fucking Sandy victims instead of some fucking spoiled brat?
I bet he just wants some of that fucking ass.
Yeah, that was stupid of him to do.
Yeah. I saw her in that fucking movie. What is that, Bad Girls?
Mean Girls.
Mean Girls. Bad Girls, Mean Great Girls, movie. Nasty Girls, Mean Girls.
She looks great.
She looked fucking amazing in that.
That was her peak.
That was her peak.
That was 2004.
2004? How old was she there?
It
could be in trouble again. Ooh, look out. Don't fucking talk about fucking Michaela Maroney.
18.
Oh, she was 18. All right. That's good. Is that good? Crazy religious right fucking idiots that are giving me shit about a gymnast and a joke I made about her hymen.
Are they still giving you shit?
Dude, and they're all, like, you click on them, all their profiles. I am go with Jesus, conservative, Republican.
Oh, I love this.
Like, somebody, like, said, dude, you read these profiles? No wonder we lost. I was like, yeah, that's her from...
That was Mean Girls, Lindsay Lohan era.
Yeah.
She's so sexy, but...
Those tits.
She's a rough 26 now.
She is so ridden hard and put up wet now. It's insane. She don't even look near good.
No. And she's just a brat. Like a, yeah. She's just a cunt.
Yeah.
She gets away with it every fucking time. How do you steal jewelry or lie to a cop about whether you were driving and not spend time in jail? How does that fucking happen?
Oh, look at her now.
You don't think that looks good?
She's just, what? 26.
She looks like shit.
Six.
Fat, dumb face.
Yeah, she's all bloaty. She got the big fake lips.
And she
man.
Was, can you, are there any Liz clips? I watched a couple.
Oh, she was so bad.
Oh, God, she's terrible.
Yeah, she was really bad in that movie. I watched it. Like, it was just a terrible movie.
Right.
But she was specifically bad in it. Like, they actually made it so that I didn't care about either of those two people.
Oh, was he bad too or no?
He wasn't great.
Who was he?
Richard Burton. I don't know who played
him. Richard Burton.
But I mean, it was an interesting story.
Did Richard Burton actor put a horrible accent on?
He had an accent, but I don't know if he naturally has one or not. But Lindsay Lohan could not keep an accent. She kept like floating in and out of an Elizabeth Taylor voice.
Oh no.
What is Elizabeth Taylor's accent?
You know, it's like pseudo British
Hollywood snob Madonna thing.
Upsy ritzy titsy bitch type shit.
Except it kept falling into raspy Long Island.
Oh.
The whole time.
Raspy Long Island. She plays that well. All right, let's hear a little of this.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth, you simply have to meet this man. This is Ernest Lehman.
I'm all right.
Sweet smell of success.
North by Northwest, we love your work.
Oh, thank you.
I wish you'd write something for me.
Actually, I have something. Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
Oh, I love the play.
But we could do it together.
Who do you start a new film? The Spy Who Came In From the Cold.
Yes, but I could do this one after that.
I'm afraid you're a little too masculine for George, and I can't quite see it. And I can't imagine the two of you fighting like that.
Oh, well, do you hear that, my little sugar tart? You can't imagine us fighting.
Well, it doesn't matter, because why would anyone hire a vomiting vat of vodka like
yourself? At least when I vomit, I make mellifluous sounds, unlike your little mouse crap squeaks.
Oh, God.
Wow. She was awful.
Horrible. Terrible. It was Lindsay Lohan.
I watched the whole movie. It was at no point...
You never got the impression that you were watching Elizabeth Taylor?
Not for one second.
You didn't get lost in the character?
Yeah, no. It's like, wow, I didn't even realize after a while. It's just watching Liz.
I was like, oh, yeah, Lindsay Lohan is a mess.
They probably told her she was brilliant.
Oh, I'm sure.
She might be nominated for this. I mean...
This was supposed to be her big comeback, like, we forgot she's a great actress.
I'm glad it flopped, because she's such a fucking snot.
Well, she's not a great actress. I don't know why anybody's ever said that. Like, she was fine in Mean Girls, but she was just playing a kid. She was a kid.
Yeah, she was just playing Lindsay Lohan, I think.
Right.
Yeah.
And she's not a good enough actress to distract from the fact that she's such a public twat and a disaster.
She can't transcend that.
And in Mean Girls, she was reading Tina Fey's lines.
Exactly.
You know?
There are a few actors that can transcend their personal problems.
Charlie Sheen did, but he was famous before, and he had done Platoon and Wall Street. He's a great actor.
I think Robert Downey is a great example.
Exactly. Possibly the best.
Transcended his personal problems.
Because he's so good. His acting is so good, you can't not want to watch him.
He's fantastic.
Not an actress, but Amy Winehouse was good enough singing. That she could do whatever she wanted. I mean, she killed herself.
Well,
but...
she killed herself, so that really isn't quite transcending.
Yeah, but you still listen to her. I still listen.
Well, you do, because you're gay.
I'm not the gayest.
You're a gee.
I'm not that gay.
Not the gayest.
No.
The gayest. Yeah, I don't know anybody else that was, like, really heavy into fucking drugs and actually came out of it.
Mel Gibson is trying, boy. Is he
Mel
trying?
Mel Gibson. His drug is racism and anti-Semitism. But wasn't he able to kind of get through that and finance his own shit?
Yeah, he always finances his own shit.
Why can't he do that now, though?
Yeah.
Like,
can
why doesn't he make
another
movie? Can you
open the fucking curtains, please?
I know. It's curtains for you.
Claustrophobic.
Yeah. It was
Mickey Rourke did it and
then
slipped back out of it.
He didn't have enough on top time to be considered
Mickey Rourke's a great actor.
There you go.
The Wrestler was awesome.
He was great in that.
Yeah, but that's fucking how many years ago?
Four?
Right.
Already?
4 years?
He hasn't done anything.
What?
As good as The Wrestler since The Wrestler.
John Travolta in a sprayed on hair.
Comebacks, I'm just looking.
Well, yeah. That Pulp Fiction comeback for him was huge.
Huge.
Yeah, not necessarily drug comebacks or anything like that.
Who else has transcended their personal...
Yeah, personal dilemmas.
Problems. There are some other actors that have.
Yeah.
Sure.
A lot of musicians, but I mean actors, because actors you have
You might be able to say Drew Barrymore.
She went through that wild stage.
Yes, as a youngster.
Celebutante stage.
Celebutante. Ooh.
She was the Lindsay Lohan of her day. If we had TMZ when Drew Barrymore was around, you know how much Drew Barrymore shit would be all over the place?
Crazy. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, she was. Yeah, she was. She was doing coke and drunk at like 12 years old.
Didn't she, wasn't she the one who went on Letterman's show and like flashed her tits?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She was already like, she had already made her comeback then. Yeah. The fucking monkey with the coat on at IKEA. Pretty adorable.
Where?
Is there? Yeah, look at that.
Oh, that's very cute. What's it doing?
A coat.
Buying IKEA.
Yeah.
Dapper monkey charms.
They are wearing a coat.
It's cold out. Aw. Monkeys are from Africa and fucking tropical places. They don't hang out in the freezing weather. Look at his little diapers.
Wearing a diaper.
In case he goes duty by mistake.
He might make some duties. Like take monkey shit and put it on that cheesecake.
Oh, and I love
That'd
a monkey.
Be great.
Or monkey paw prints in it because their fucking chimp hands are so dirty.
Yes.
Do you know how a monkey would tear up a cheesecake? If you sat a fucking monkey in front of a cheesecake, it would just rip it up with its hands and eat it.
It really would.
30 seconds with a cheesecake and then you rebox it.
Right.
There you go. It would be destroyed. I love monkeys, but they cannot handle fine cake.
No, and they're filthy. You don't ever want to take something from a monkey's hand and eat it. If a monkey offers you a snack, turn it down.
Do you know a monkey? I shared a bottle of water with a monkey. When he was sitting on my lap, he drank some.
Oh, I remember that.
And then he put it in my mouth. And they're usually very selfish. They don't do that.
That was
Mikey. Mikey the chimp. And, and he did that for me years before. And they normally do not share. So I felt it was a great honor.
That was very cute.
Wasn't that cute?
I like
that.
What did it taste like? What did it taste
just
like?
Just water. It's all he cares.
Monkey water?
Chimp, yeah.
Monkey breath water?
He was very cute. And he did remember me.
Mikey did?
That's so weird that he remembered you.
Yeah, the primate. It took a while.
He had a little monkey face. Goddamn fucking monkeys.
They're adorable.
I wanted a monkey so bad when I was a kid. Aww. Like, every kid wants a monkey. Doesn't every kid kind of want a monkey?
I guess, hypothetically. But most kids, I don't think of it as a reality. Like, oh, this is something I want to do.
Most
Because when I watched The Little Rascals, Spanky always had a monkey.
Oh, we didn't watch Little Rascals because I'm much younger than that.
Reruns.
Oh.
Like I was in the 30s watching them first run.
I don't know. What's a rerun?
Oh, very
good. Fat guy who died eventually because he's had diabetes and he used to be a good dancer. We got it, Jim. We got it.
I was watching Cy's Christmas performance that he filmed on Sunday.
From
How
the
was
White
it?
House?
The DC one?
He didn't. They don't say Gangnam Style.
Oh, what? Let's hear
this. No, I knew this.
Yeah.
I said
you want to watch the whole
intro up until.
Does he say Fuck America Style?
Yeah.
That's what I thought.
Yes.
Either Obama or White House Style? America
Style. You got any more volume over there?
Come on.
Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Jack Frost
he
nipping.
Stinks.
Yuletide carols. Being somebody.
South Korea rappers can be very feminine.
Yeah.
American rappers could
He's
not.
He's terrible.
Like that.
No.
This is not the reason why I'm here.
Oh! That's the reason! Who gives a shit?
His song.
That's the big surprise?
All right.
Oh, he's doing the dance.
He must hate this. All right.
But he knows it's over afterwards.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, he does.
He's performing for the president. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
This Where's the president?
Yeah.
All right, some boys dancing with him.
Yeah, the boys.
Very fruity. Now he's a big, he's in a Christmas red, too.
All right, what happened?
What happened?
Oh.
Santa Fe.
Oh, no.
Oh my God!
Christmas style.
It's Christmas.
Oh, my head itches.
Embarrassing. They're dressed like reindeer.
Christmas style.
All right, with the dumb fucking dance.
Santa Baby.
Oh, I just got a douche chill.
Whoop on Christmas Star.
Wow. When they do a retrospective of from 2010 to 2020, everyone's going to go, oh, God, remember?
Yeah.
Remember that?
Remember Psy?
Yeah. Oh,
man. Hello, Macarena.
I forgot that.
Why is hold on. Why is my fucking iPhone light going low?
It does it sometimes.
Why? Well, just, why?
I don't know.
Why don't you just click the
button? Yeah, just button click on top. The top button.
And, yeah.
Cocksucker.
What an awful piece of technology.
It's the ghost of Steve Jobs getting in the machine. Ghost in the machine, man. It's a conspiracy.
That was terrible.
Do you think like he Christmas style?
No.
Do you think he knows he's
Christmas style?
He is Macarena and Who Let the Dogs Out? And
I don't know, because he's bigger than them because of the YouTube. YouTube, when you have 600 million hits.
Craziness.
When almost a billion people have seen you, you've bought some longevity. Because there's just too many people for you to go away immediately.
Yeah, but nobody's going to want to hear another song from him.
I would love to. What will the follow-up to Gangnam Style? It'll be something.
There's other Psy songs, right?
There are, yeah. He's tried it.
Yeah, they sound just like...
Since then?
Yeah, he's had songs come out since then.
Oh!
Pretty girl.
Yeah, sexy fellas for the guys.
Oh.
He came out with Christmas Style and Mashup Style.
I just sometimes go around my house and say that. I go around the house sometimes and just go, morning mashup style, just for no reason.
Well, it's catchy.
Yeah.
It's in your head.
I talk to myself a lot at home.
The wrong number of syllables.
Yeah. Yeah, that doesn't work. Open and ante style. No. Yeah. No. Owen Day style doesn't work.
Mm-mm.
No.
Too bad, too, because we could have gotten on this trend just as it's getting
Jimmy
hot.
Jimmy Norton style works.
Even Sam Roberts style, that works.
No, it doesn't.
It works pretty well.
Eric Nagel style.
Yes. Eric Nagel style, that works perfectly.
Tank Hankra style.
Dom Virus style. No. Oh, on Ellen. How many times has he performed
I'm
this?
Just curious to see if he does.
I see.
Like
Ellen style?
Yeah.
Well, by Ellen. Oh, no, Ellen style.
I don't know if he does or not.
I don't either.
Uh-oh. Almost 6 million views.
It's got like 800 million on
video.
No. Oh, they're all dancing now, the fat yentas.
No. Everybody bows! Come on! Oh, no, he just did it. Alright, good. I think he's going to do it Ellen style.
That's what I know.
And then they all put their hands up in front of their face like they're parting something and they flick their tongue out.
They start scissoring on the floor.
Putting on fake penises.
Whoop, 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 whoop.
He doesn't even sing half the song.
No, he doesn't. Yeah. Why would he? Let the record play.
You think this is played in clubs?
Yeah.
Still?
Yeah, Troy says it's still
really. Really?
There's nothing that sounds more dated than like a 2 or 3 year old club song.
Yeesh.
Like, I remember when I went to Brazil, what was the big club songs in like 2003 and 4? Because they were playing them in the club we went into.
Sam? Comment?
In a club?
This is for my people. My people. Oh, who the fuck is that? It was a good club song. Oh. I mean, but it's so fucking...
Missy Elliott?
Yeah, play that a little bit, but this was what was playing in Brazil. I remember it in 2004. My mother club has, you feel me? Do you remember this? This was fucking huge.
Motherfucking Missy Elliott. What happened to Missy Elliott? Where'd she go?
But it sounds, the club song sounds terribly dated.
Yeah.
You don't know this or no?
Not really.
How about find KY's Stomp? Did we play that recently? We talked about it.
What?
No?
Doesn't ring a bell.
I remember I went and saw this guy. This was a huge song when I was just getting sober, I think. KY's. And the song was called Stomp.
KY's.
But I remember I went and saw him live at a club.
Yeah.
I didn't think I was doing stand up yet. I might have been.
Sam, you want to pop that up?
KY's.
Yeah.
Oh, this sounds old.
Oh, God, yeah.
Oh, this is so old school.
That's oh, K-R-O-Y. Remember some girls were trying to jump in the limo with them.
I saw some hammer pants.
This is so... What year was this song? I'm guessing. Is it 91 or 92?
Damn.
Sorry, it stumped.
I can't even listen to it. It's terrible, but I mean...
Crazy.
Stomp, whatever it was.
They look too goofy to even be threatening. Like, they weren't gangster rappers enough.
No.
What? He's here.
Oh.
Oh.
Well, I
text you about
no, I know, but I said now, and you said then.
Yeah, yeah, I said 3 minutes before he does the next
interview. He's here.
Can I go now? Yeah, yeah, I would go now. That's
why I didn't say it. Get a fucking picture. Jimmy's going to get a picture. Get a picture, Jimmy. Well, I got to get Jimmy's plugs. See if he comes back.
Famous picture style.
Jimmy loves celebrity pictures. Jimmy loves celebrity pictures.
That was so funny and childlike today when he said, imagine if for the 12-12-12 thing they charged $1 million to take a picture with everybody.
First of all, any fantasy scenario that includes $1 million is a juvenile fantasy.
But then it's he tries to justify it a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. All right, maybe not that much. But it's like, yeah, what would you do with $1 million? Ah, would you do that for $1 million? It's like $1 million, just it's kind of goofy.
It probably costs like $1 jillion.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wouldn't do that for a Googleplex.
Oh,
there's no number higher than Googleplex.
That's where Google came from.
Googleplex?
Yeah.
Or did you just say that?
No, I think it is.
Oh,
I think that's where they got the name from. That's like another one of those things that who thought we'd be saying words like Google?
Google.
Google.
I held out so long trying to still use Yahoo search when everyone was using Google.
Yahoo.
I'm like, nah, Yahoo's better. And then one day I had to admit.
But... I remember going on message boards and begging people for Gmail invites.
Gmail.
Oh, yeah. Danny gave me my Gmail invite. Yeah. I was so appreciative.
When that shit was new, because you got like 3 gigs of storage or something.
Yeah. And you needed to be invited.
Yeah.
It was a cool club.
Retarded.
And then I just wanted to go and give people my email address. Yeah, Gmail. Yeah.
You know. I don't know how I got it.
Yeah, well, don't worry about it. It's an invite thing, but I only got a few, so.
Maybe when I get some more. And then finally, like, you always had 99 invites, and it didn't matter anymore.
And then eventually it was just open.
It was just open.
Does anyone even care about that anymore?
About Gmail?
About that. No, the Gmail.
Google Plus?
Google Plus, yeah.
Oh, Google Plus is over.
Totally done.
It's very hard to create a social network.
Yeah.
Like, it almost always fails. Like Facebook didn't set out to do, you know, to
you got
to
have a slow build.
Yeah, exactly. Like, Facebook was meant for college students. And look, Apple failed so hard with Ping.
Apple 5?
You Ping?
Know? Yeah.
I use Ping on my Apple 5.
I don't really trust the other social networks, but...
No, but...
Ping is always...
You know, it's got a nice Apple on it.
Shiny, silver.
That chick rules. Still hasn't been fleshed out, huh? Can't figure out who she is, where she's from.
No.
Love to have her on the show.
Nice. Yeah.
She was great. Oh, he was a nice guy?
Very nice guy. And he's a great character on that show. I love him.
He had a beard?
He looks exactly the way.
Good. I hate it when people don't look like they look on TV.
Does it happen a lot?
All the time.
Yeah. Do you have to meet with a boss today? Kenny just asked me.
No.
Okay, good.
No, Kenny. We're going home. Yeah, I got shit to do. All right, Jimmy,
you got a cheesecake to give away.
I know. Yeah, yeah. I got to get home for the great cheesecake exchange.
You got to fart 40 times before he gets there.
Big fucking cheesecake exchange.
All right, let me whore this nonsense. No Baby For You is available on iTunes now, Amazon.com. It comes out today. On sale this Friday will be my February 17th date at the Borgata. Myself, Dave Attell, Artie Lang, and Amy Schumer has been added. Amy is on fucking fire. She's doing nothing but theaters now, so it's nice to watch another friend rocket past me.
Oh, boy.
Buffalo, Monday, December 28th through 31st, to New Year's Eve.
Yes.
And April 11th through 14th, here in New York at Caroline's. January 10th through 12th in Nashville at Zany's. And then my first time in San Diego doing stand-up, 25 and 26th of January in the American Comedy Company. So I hope people come out and watch that fucking concert. Is that tomorrow?
Yeah.
Oh, 12-12-12.
Yeah, it's on Epix and it's on a bunch of other networks.
I think
so.
We're streaming it on a couple channels here, too.
I think I'll be live tweeting that one.
It's going to be a good one.
Yeah, we should.
I can't watch it.
Fun. Why?
I'm fucking doing karate.
Goddamn, Jerry.
I don't know what I'm talking about.
All right, people. Same bat time. Same bat channel.
See you tomorrow. See how long has it been since I've seen a vagina in person?
Really?
Yes. Who's showing me? Fucking nobody is showing me their vagina.
The OP and Anthony Show is available later today with SiriusXM On Demand. You've heard about it. You've waited 4 long hours for it. Finally, the moment is at hand. And after OP and Anthony Live is coming up next!